The following is a copyrighted presentation of the Southwest Athletic Conference in conjunction with Raycom.
When Texas A&M comes to Lubbock to play Texas Tech, strange things happen. Have won four of the last six against the Aggies on the South Plains. Today, a sellout crowd awaits as Texas A&M tries to overcome the Texas Tech Hex on Raycom. Southwest Conference Football, and it's brought to you by Southwest Airlines, celebrating 20 years of providing everyday low fares and convenient flights to many exciting destinations. Also brought to you in part by NCNB, by Bud Light, by Dr. Pepper, by Exxon Phase 4 Gasoline, and by Buick. We've got perfect fall football weather and one of the largest crowds in Jones Stadium history today as the number 23 Aggies of Texas A&M visit the Red Raiders of Texas Tech. And we and the Parachuters all welcome you to Jones Stadium in Lubbock. Dave Barnett, along with former NFL All-Pro defensive lineman Dave Rowe. Whatever it is out here has always brought some of the closest games in Southwest Conference history when the Aggies come west to play the Red Raiders. In these six meetings, dating back to 79, three decided by 1 point, and Dave, the average margin has been 2.5 points per game.
And Dave, one common thread that each one of these games had was tremendous emotion, and we have that emotion here today. Spike Dykes knows that with 50,000 people in the stands, a huge game, if that emotion comes out, watch out.
1-3, obviously a disappointing start for Texas Tech. However, they have not had their entire offensive package together until today.
No, this is really the return of Rodney Blackshear and Lloyd Hill. We see the downfield catch average of Blackshear, 22 yards per catch, and Hill in only four games had 23 receptions.
Really, the Aggies can tell a similar tale because they haven't had their original starting backfield together since the first series of their first game against LSU.
Well, it all starts with the A&M backfield, of course, with Bucky Richardson, Hill with that 6.2 yard average, but the return of Doug Carter with that great blocking ability has really got to boost them today.
Home teams won the last five in this series, and the Red Raiders hope that trend continues. We'll return after this from Southwest Airlines.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Shining in the Texas sky, the Lone Star is flying high.
Plays every game with an intensity that brings honor to his team, his school, and the very sport itself. Now, you can honor him. Stop at Exxon and vote the best players onto the Exxon Southwest Conference Supreme Team.
Don't care about movie stars who live in Hollywood. Don't like their attitude, don't think I ever could. Don't want the good taste, I know I taste good. Why the best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered.
Masked Rider making the first appearance of the afternoon here at Jones Stadium, where temperatures are in the 50s. Yesterday, winds were above 20 miles per hour. They have calmed today, and wind for Lubbock won't be that much of a factor, as the Red Raiders will take on R.C. Slocum's 2-1 Texas A&M Aggies. That's the best start by any A&M coach, 19-8-1, and we check the Southwest Airlines team must today for A&M.
Of course, when you start thinking about predictability, A&M must force them into the obvious passing situations. No one can defend both against a run and pass on every down. In unpredictability, the Aggies want to mix up their own attack. Pass on first down, run on third down. And Bucky Richardson, when he drops back in that third down situation, he is always a threat to run and pick up the first down.
In his fifth year as head coach here at Tech, Spike Dykes, a little above 500, right at 2-2 against the Aggies in his career, and the Tech team must.
Well, first of all, they've been killed by the big plays, both offensively and defensively. If they strike early, they get their confidence and keep that emotion, that's what they need to stay in this football game. And they have just been unable to capitalize in those three losses on opportunities that were just given to them, Dave.
Those are our Southwest Airlines team musts. Terry Venetulius will kick for the Aggies. And Rodney Blackshear, who has yet to return a kick this year, but a tremendous threat, along with Donald Marshall, back deep for the Red Raiders. Stadium and underway. Venetulius 9 yards deep to Blackshear. Red Raiders will go from their 20. And senior quarterback Jamie Gill out of Hurstville, a three-year letterman. Three touchdowns and three interceptions, but he finally has that full complement of very dangerous wide receivers to go to today. Along with Gill offensively, Lynn and Sheffield in the backfield. Hume is the tight end. Blackshear, who, as you saw, was the best deep threat in the nation last year, getting over a fractured leg. Stinnett, the fastest wide receiver. Stance LaBye, transfer from West Texas, making his first Division I start at right guard. And on first down, the tailback, Anthony Lynn, is buried for a loss of one. Flag after Anthony Lynn is wrestled down at the 12, and this may be personal foul A&M.
I believe it is. They just never let up once the whistle blew. The official was right there.
This is Bud Alexander, the referee, and that's exactly what it is. Maybe a little too much emotion for A&M.
Well, they had stuffed them on the line, and the official came up and blew the whistle, and they just kind of continued. And when he went down, that official reached for that yellow flag. We can see it here. Now, he stopped on the line. There's the whistle. And this is where the official just sees it, and he says, hey, you're not letting up. And you in the background, he picks up the flag out of his pocket and throws it.
Big break from the 35. And this is the fullback Sheffield, senior from San Antonio Wheatley, is near the 45-yard line. The Aggie defense with Sam Adams, the freshman from Cypress Creek, true freshman, making his first start at left defensive end. The linebackers a little bit on the banged up side. Marcus Buckley's had a bruised thigh. Quentin Coriat has had an upset stomach all morning, but he does start. And in the secondary, Kevin Smith, the all-time career interceptor in the Southwest Conference, at left corner. Second and short for Gill. Nobody there, and he is sacked at the 34 by Lance Tackleman.
That's just great coverage in the secondary because really Gill, as he stood back there, had plenty of time to pick up his receivers, but they were covered. There, look at the time he has. No one to throw to. Now a late flush out of the pocket, and he's got nowhere to go. They contain him and tackle him.
And Dave, significant that that was the forward line surge and not a blitz. R.C. Slocum does not expect to get a lot of blitzing opportunities today against the Red Raiders. Gill on third down, Wheatley senior, Lewis Sheffield, and the San Antonio native drops at the 32, and that'll bring up fourth and long. Adams and Chris Crooms, the strong safety, combining on the tackle. And Mark Bounds leads the conference and is within 0.05 of a yard of leading the nation with that 45.9 average. Kevin Smith, rather than true freshman Wilbert Biggins, returning punts. And it is Smith from the 19. Room up the middle. And a return of a 46-yard kick for 15 yards. Bucky Richardson, injured in that opener against LSU, came back against Southwestern Louisiana last week. And in a very trying situation for the Aggies, they really needed and got Richardson's leadership last week. Greg Hill, one of the top running backs in the country, as a redshirt freshman. Doug Carter, the junior from Dallas Thomas Jefferson, returning after he sprained an ankle early against LSU. Dexter Wesley, banged up on that offensive line, did not practice much this week because of a bad back. Out of the eye on first down. Good. Up the middle yardage for Hill. And he will be very close for a first down. The Red Raider defense going from a 4-3 to a 3-4 this year. And Fred Petty, by far their best up front defender. Matt Wingo, the second leading tackler in the conference last year. That weak inside linebacker. And in the secondary, we told you about Kevin Smith. Tracy Saul, a junior, may pass Kevin Smith's Southwest Conference career record by the time he's done. Greg Hill time again, and he's out near midfield with another flag down. Wingo on the stop.
Of course, there's the 30 on the back of Texas A&M's helmets, Dave.
Well, that, of course, was the number of the late James Glenn, who passed away a little over a week ago in practice of still undetermined causes. He was the freshman from League City who kicked off three times at Tulsa a couple of weeks ago. We got to see him play, and right after that game, prior to a practice session, collapsed on the practice field, passed away. Aggies have had about a week and a half to emotionally deal with that loss. And Slocum says, boy, as tough as that was, we have got to move on. First and 10 after the walk-off. And Hill again, his third carry. He's had sizable yardage on all three.
Boy, and what Hill does so well is run under control. That's just a big sweep out there. You've got your guards out in front of you, you're blocking back, and all of a sudden he sees the pile, and he's going to watch this. He's going to see the pile, and then he's going to cut back up underneath and pick up the yards. And there's nothing outside. He's got nowhere to go there. He has to cut back underneath and watch the yardage he picks up. Just a great decision by that young man.
Picked up 8 on first down, second and short. And this is Doug Carter, the fullback. Thunders near the 15. Tracy Saul from free safety wrestled him down.
And there's the compliment of Greg Hill, and that's, of course, Carter on that fullback dive. If you don't respect that, all of a sudden a quarterback sticks it in his stomach, and he rips downfield for 8 to 10 yards.
They've been great out of the gate this year. 2 touchdowns and a field goal on their opening drive in their first 3 games, and they're in position to continue that trend. First and 10 at the 18, Hill. They just keep pounding at that middle. And this is the best he has been defensed. They get 3 on first down. Let's check the Dr. Pepper scoreboard for the first time today. NC State stung by, or stinging North Carolina last week and shutting out Georgia Tech in a big ACC battle in the second period. Miami and Oklahoma State, as expected. And number 22, Illinois. And number 16, Auburn, also underway. Richardson wants timeout. The play clock had 6 seconds on it, so he didn't like what he saw on the Red Raider defense of the line.
Introducing the Bud Light Jaguar Racing Team. Catch it this season.
How do we get the truck back?
Throw it in reverse.
Let's go!
Why Farm Bureau Insurance?
Their rates are competitive and help me get great coverage for my money.
When you have a claim, Farm Bureau service is fair and fast.
Our agent put together a plan to help save for their future.
Helping you is what we do best. That's why people across America, from every walk of life, depend on Farm Bureau Insurance.
Americans like you.
And you don't even have to be a farmer, just smart.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
Nuh-uh. A new bath.
Kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs?
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
A deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
The Aggies have marched from their 34 to the Red Raider 15. Greg Hill on the season and on the day, averaging right at 6 yards per carry. And he has moved into the number 4 slot among Aggie freshman rushers in history, well on pace to surpass that Curtis Dickey record from 1975. Long count after the timeout. Option pitch. And the cutback only to the 13 as Wingo from weak side linebacker reacted quickly. Their leading tackler again this year. Second only to Mick Thomas of Arkansas last year.
Well, one of the players they have got to control in there is Fred Petty, number 17. They're taking two people, and you can see Dawson's just locked on him there. Boy, almost pulled his jersey off.
The Aggies have not had a third and long or even intermediate yardage needed on this drive. They do now. They need 5, and Richardson overthrows the intended receiver, Ben Mitchell. Lucky, of course, a runner first, a thrower second in his career at A&M. And the incompletion brings up the field goal situation for Venetulius. The sophomore from Deer Park, 3-4 this year with a long of 44. That was last week against Southwestern Louisiana. And there is virtually no win factor at all. This will be 31 yards out of the hold of Brian Payne. And he is good. So the Aggies, for the fourth straight game, score on their opening drive. They lead 3-0. Texas Tech, of course, at 1-3. They hope that they can really start a surge in 91 with this game. Spike Dyke says they're not a 1-3 team in his mind.
Our team is not a bad football team. People asked me this week, said, well, I guess y'all expected too much of them when you started, and you're off to a bad, and we're off to a bad start. I haven't played very good. But I don't think it's not Harry Carey time yet. I think it's time to really cinch it up another notch, really go back to the basics, work your tail off to try to get better, make the improvement necessary, and have a good football team.
I like a guy who is that candid about his own team. You know, we don't deserve to be much better, but potentially we can be a lot better.
Well, as a typical coach, though, yesterday in our meetings, he kept on saying, if we had just done this, if this had just come to, if we'd been able to convert those three third down and ones last week.
He's got a whole string of near misses so far. This kick could have been returned, but Blackshear, just a half yard deep or so, elects not to do so. So again, from their 20, the Red Raiders will go. Blackshear last year, second in the nation in combined receiving and kick returning yardage. And we're pleased to welcome those of you joining us on Prime Network and its nationwide family of regional sports cable networks. That Aggie drive covered 52 yards over eight plays. Raider defense stiffened, and it's 3-0. New backfield behind Gill. The fullback is Anthony McDowell, who has returned from 2 years of academic problems, and he goes nowhere up the middle.
Boy, Patrick Henry made a great play that time, returning from that dislocated shoulder or elbow. He just came right around the center and had him in the backfield before he even got started. It's number 98. Watch how quickly he's going to come backside. Swim move, get it right around, get that balance, and he's got him in the backfield.
What do you mean when you say swim move?
Well, what you do is you actually, it almost looks like a bullfighter. You just kind of dodge him. And it's like a swimming stroke over top of him with your arms.
Donald Marshall, speedster at tailback, not quick enough to get away from Chris Crooms. Dyke says the Aggies have all three S's. They've got side, they've got speed, and they've got strength. And Chris Crooms at 6'3", 184, showing his quickness from strong safety.
Well, Dave, you're certainly not going to make a living against this Texas A&M team going wide. You've got great speed at the corners, as you said, to get outside, and they just keep on stringing it along, and soon you just run out of room. You're at the sideline. You've got to turn up.
Lloyd Hill is in the game, and wide left, Stinnett wide right, and Blackshear in motion. And Gill under pressure, dropped again by Adams.
And Gill is down. Sam Adams just smothered him.
Well, that's Adams at 6'4", 270. And that skill at 6'2", 210 gives up 60 pounds in that physical matchup. And Gill, who was bothered virtually all last year by one injury after another, is almost motionless where Adams dropped him back at the 10-yard line.
Well, Adams just does an inside move, and he is clear as soon as the ball. He's going to be coming from the right part of your screen, and he is just clean right away. Boom. Now Gill is going to see him and all of a sudden start bailing out to his left. And watch Adams when he just engulfs him and smashes him down to the ground. The ball was under there too, Dave.
Ball in the left shoulder also got bent at an odd angle underneath Gill's own weight, and then Adams' weight on top of that.
Of course, this Sam Adams' first start. A heralded freshman coming in, or I should say high school senior coming out of here. I played against his dad and played with his dad. Sam Adams, great offensive guard for the New England Patriots.
And they knew it would only be a matter of time before he moved into the starting lineup. Took him only four games. Gill obviously favoring that left elbow or shoulder. And when we get word, we'll let you know what the diagnosis is. They have a very experienced backup quarterback in Robert Hall. And because of all Gill's problems last year, Hall got a lot of playing time. In fact, in the Aggie game last year at College Station, Hall played all but two series because Gill was bothered by the flu bug that week. And he had him on the Aggie 15 late with a chance to pull that one out. Better known as a runner than a passer, he is only a 44% passer this year, and that's where they really give something up when Gill has to go out.
Now you see the pads that Gill wears, those are rib pads to protect the rib areas. There's very little protection in that upper body and the shoulders.
Devin Smith at his 40, and the Aggies look like they'll come after Mark Bounds. But his protection is good, and he gets off a low wobbler with a Red Raider roll to the 39, and that's all for Smith. Right there on him was Brian Tucker. 3-0 Aggies. We return after this from Southwest Airlines.
Ever since Southwest Airlines introduced our Friends Fly Free sale, people have gotten friendlier.
Sugar Plum, your favorite pillow.
If you make reservations and buy your round-trip ticket at our regular low unrestricted fare by October 31st, a friend gets to fly with you this fall, free.
Hey, Dad, seen the hedge trimmer?
You and a friend can travel through January 6th.
Here's that putter I borrowed last year, old buddy.
Southwest Airlines Friends Fly Free sale. It's great for your pocketbook and your popularity.
Don't wreck your life.
Once again, Buick is raising the banner for quality in America. Introducing the 1992 LeSabre. With a higher level of power, safety, security, and convenience. This new LeSabre is going to be one tough act to follow. LeSabre for 1992 from Buick.
Whole couple of sections over there of Raider red faces. You know, there's a strong resemblance to Yosemite Sam.
Rootin' tootin' Raider.
And Jamie Gill heads to the locker room. We will give you word as soon as we get it on exactly what Sam Adams hurt. As the Aggies go from the 38-yard line. Mitchell, the man in motion. And a flag down as Richardson keeps on the option and is into Red Raider territory. Tracy Saul chased him out after a gain of 14, and we'll see if the gain stands or not. Bucky Richardson knows what Jamie Gill's going through. He has had much of his career marred by injuries. Of course, the big one was the knee, which he hurt a few years ago against Texas. That basically cost him two full seasons in his rehab work. And then a sprained arch early in the LSU game cost him plenty of time. The penalty is motion Aggies, so his 14-yard gain is going to come back. And if you didn't know before, just another object lesson in why you have got to have more than one good, healthy quarterback in this conference.
They're only good for one play if it's a bad one. They're out. We just got word that Gill's injury is his left shoulder, as we said, and he is being x-rayed.
Aggies go to the offset eye. Slocum says we'll see a lot of this today. Cliff Gross went in motion. And again, on the option, Richardson turns it up, and look out. Donnie Brooks chased him down, but he got 23.
And Dave, this is an interesting formation because, as you said, it's called the offset eye, where they use three backs. Now, when he takes the ball, he fakes in here. Boom, that holds the linebacker. Now he goes down the line, looks for the pitch. It's not there, so he turns back up. The biggest area that you can gain yardage is backside, and that's what Richardson does on that play. Goes all the way back against the grain and picks up a great gain.
Hill and Randy Simmons in the eye. Simmons is the fullback. He's been bothered by a bruised shoulder this week, and it's Hill straight into the pile. And a pickup of 3 or 4. Had he cut right, he had the entire side of the field to himself over there. Let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the Raycom Network. Cool, cloudless weather in Lubbock, Texas today. Dave Barnett along with Dave Rowe from Jones Stadium, where 50,000 plus have seen the Aggies get a field goal from Terry Venetulius. And they look for more from the Raider 41. Second and 8. Richardson, under pressure, escapes and salvages maybe a half yard before Ben Kirkpatrick trips him up from right outside linebacker. Upset possibly in the making at Auburn. Only second quarter.
Dave, you hate to say big plays and continually make that cliche, but this is a big play as Richardson checks this call on his arm. This is a big play for Texas Tech. They've lost their quarterback. Their emotions are wavering. They really need to stop this third down play by Texas A&M.
Out of the shotgun with the flag down, Richardson over the middle and caught. Ryan Mitchell. They'll mark him inside the 1 yard line, but remember, a flag is down.
Well, I looked down the line and Fred Petty lined up offsides. His hand was right next to the ball. And this play is going to stand because he was in the neutral zone.
Richardson paid for it, but he hits Mitchell for 39 yards.
There's Petty in the center of your screen. Look at the time Richardson has out there. Not known as a great passer, and that's a tough pattern. Coming across on that crossing pattern to lead Brian Mitchell, and he picks up huge yardage. This is Richardson again, just standing back in that pocket. Not under a lot of pressure, late pressure, but really has a lot of time to throw.
What a deep threat the freshman from Dallas Carter has turned into. Mitchell averaging 34 yards per catch this year. First and goal. Greg Hill time. But he can't get in.
I thought for a minute Hill was going to lose that ball. He had it up high in his chest as he was trying to wiggle around in there. That's when the ball can be ripped out. Let's see if we can see that. When he takes the handoff, he has the ball. Wait, see how he has it way out there in front of him. Boy, that's a freshman mistake. You know that coaches will tell him about that Monday morning. You don't do that.
I bet they don't wait till Monday morning to tell him about that.
Probably too.
Second and goal. Richardson, touchdown. Contingent of Aggies on hand in Lubbock, and that drive appropriately capped by the senior quarterback from Baton Rouge because he was a one-man show on the drive. Venetulius' extra point, 10-0.
Well, when you're a 220-plus pound quarterback, you can run quarterback sneaks. Richardson, about 222, 223 pounds. He just powers in there, jumps over top, and gets a great line surge. And there's Bucky's reaction when he gets up. Boom. All right. Think he's not happy to be back playing?
A lot of time to go first quarter. 5:25 remaining, but the Red Raiders already in a 10-0 hole.
George Strait, Country Music's Entertainer of the Year.
Larry Zonka, three straight Super Bowls. Come on. After that, he went to see sports personalities, as well as our own team of sports instructors, help host Norwegian Cruise Line cruises. No other cruise line has such an all-star lineup. Norwegian Cruise Line, the best vacation you've ever had. Plus, contact with someone like number 39, Larry Zonka.
There is a new gasoline that is clearly advanced. A new gasoline that will give you the highest level of engine cleaning for high performance. A new gasoline formulated for lower pollution and cleaner air. Who has this new gasoline? You know who. New Phase 4 gasoline from Exxon. For high performance and cleaner air.
R.C. Slocum may have a 10-0 lead midway first quarter, but He says against this Red Raider offense, you can't expect any early lead necessarily to hold up. Benatulius drills another one for a touchback, and he is 3 for 3 causing touchbacks. Bucky Richardson scoring run, making it 10-0. And the drive against Spike Dykes' defense, covering 6 plays and 63 yards. And Dykes, from the looks of how Gill landed and the fact that he was carted off, you would think has got to say that Robert Hall is my man probably the rest of the way today.
Absolutely, and there's two things that can happen when you bring in a new quarterback. You either rally around him and play fantastic, or else you sink and everybody has a bad day.
Lynn from Ibach looks for cutting up room and finds a couple of yards, maybe. Kiefer Chatham, backup left defensive end from Waco, was there on the stop. Lynn had a good game at A&M last year, a good year last year. He was fifth in the conference at almost 900 yards, but the room hasn't been there for him this year, and he's averaged less than 4 yards per carry, which is one reason that the Raider offensive line got some shaking up this week. And it'll be third and long. Otis Neely, outside linebacker, junior from Lamarck, on the tackle for the fired up Aggie defense.
And you said the Aggies weren't going to blitz much? Boy, that was a blitz. He came just roaring down that line, Neely did.
Well, Slocum says the reason Tech is a tough team to blitz is because they keep so many blockers in. They basically put 3 wideouts on the pattern, and that's it. The backs stay in, the tight end stays in, and there are no open alleys for the outside linebackers to shoot through. Obvious passing situation. Hall lets it fly. Yeah. By Lloyd Hill. One of the most decorated recruits in Tech history. High school All-American from Odessa Permian. Here's why they have missed him so badly.
Well, he just makes a seam between he and the cornerback. Just makes great room in there and looks the ball in. But Hall, not known as a passing quarterback, threw a perfect strike.
Hill had an Achilles problem last year. In fact, that happened before the A&M game. He's had a knee that just wouldn't heal right until this week, this year.
I think Derek Frazier is still down.
He was the defender for the A&M secondary who brought Hill down. And he has only now made his way to his feet.
I thought a real interesting comment that R.C. Slocum made about his cornerbacks. Everybody talks about Kevin Smith. He said, let me tell you, Derek Frazier's only about a step behind him.
Which is why he doesn't expect teams to pick on Frazier. Smith has a reputation, but he says, well, they're making a mistake if they think that Frazier is worth picking on. Very little room for Lynn in the first quarter.
Well, one thing A&M is getting is great penetration into the backfield. That'll mess it up faster than anything. When you bring that outside backer, you shoot one of those linemen, those linebackers through the hole, it just creates a big clutter back there, and they're getting that, just absolutely stopping it right on the line.
This is the second leading defense in the Southwest Conference this year, behind only Texas. Tech much improved defensively, but they were near the bottom all last year. Here comes the blitz. Down goes Hall. Ball is free. And Marcus Buckley at the bottom of the pile. Otis Neely and Buckley coming from outside linebacker. And +6 now on that turnover ratio for A&M.
Well, Hall is just looking strong side. He never sees the shot in the back. That plays just like it's designed. You hit him in the back, cause the fumble, and I'll be there to recover it.
Buckley caused it. Neely covered it. And on first down, Richardson going deep. Has a man too much. intended for Tony Harrison. And he had a good 4 or 5 steps on that left corner, Anthony Wiley. Harrison already with 4 touchdown catches this year. You got to go back 2 years to find the last time an Aggie wideout caught as many as 5 touchdowns in an entire season. At the conclusion of today's game, Dave and I will announce the Southwest Airlines Player of the Game. Stay with us. Keep that in mind. 2nd and 10. Greg Hill inside the 40. Bring up 3rd and short. Steve Carr, the strong inside linebacker, on the tackle. Hill, who debuted with 212 yards against LSU, comes in 8th in the nation at 406 yards prior to this game. Ryan Matthews, wide right, Harrison left. Passing set on 3rd and 4, and Richardson with time. Flushed out, 1st down and more.
One of the things that R.C. Slocum told us is that we want to be unpredictable. This is a definite pass situation. He said, but we want to use Bucky Richardson when he gets back there with that great scrambling ability. Make those defensive linemen go a little bit wide, let Bucky see the seam. And they know what the coverage that A&M, that Tech is going to have against them, that they're going to be deep and it's going to leave a lot of room. Richardson sees it, picks up the 1st down.
It's not quite a quarterback draw because he legitimately is looking for a receiver, but not for long. Hill the lone setback. And again, yardage up the middle. He'll be close for another 1st down at the 20 before Wingo makes the tackle.
I think the greatest thing that Hill has is quick feet. When he gets into the hole, he has the ability to get those feet down very quickly and make a cut around the pile. Watch this when he gets the ball. He has those fast feet right there. Quick, boom, boom, boom. Get around the pile, find that open hole, and pick up the big yardage.
He gives his mom credit for those quick feet. He says she used to chase him down the sidelines in high school. I had to stay ahead of my mom when I had a chance to score. 2nd and less than 1. And near the 10 is the fullback, Doug Carter. Boy, he moved the pile, and it'll be 1st from the 12-yard line, 1st down A&M. Already leading 10-0. As is Illinois against Minnesota. And this is a Tech team that you said needs confidence. They have not gotten what they needed early in the way of a big boost.
Oh, and they've taken this 50,000-plus crowd out of the football game. They're just sitting here just watching.
17-0 would be tough without Jamie Gill. Hill inside the 10 and the 5. He's close to 1st and goal. Brian Dubisky came up from strong safety.
Another great cut. This time he steps over top of a pile once he gets into the secondary. He takes the ball. He gets good vision in the hole. Right there, those quick feet again. Slashes through. Now makes the decision to come all the way back. Steps over top of the pile and almost goes all the way in.
Well, they are sticking to their plan. They're bringing up 2nd and short on a regular basis. This is about a foot needed. And Greg Hill again near the goal line.
Well, I thought he put the ball on the goal line again. He looked like he reached out with that football. That's a very dangerous move to make down there. See if, in fact, he doesn't put the ball, stretch the ball out and touch the goal line. Another good decision. There's a pile outside, so you slash it back up underneath. Now, watch him reach out with that football, and he touches the line.
Evidently, they say the knees were down. And Richardson sneaking again. Did he get in?
Well, there was great penetration on the left side, but he does sneak in.
You could just see Spike Dyke's shoulders sagging more than a little bit.
As Ventatulius can make it 17-0 with 17 seconds to go in the first quarter.
It's on the sideline, Bucky Richardson. He's having a great day. Two runs for short yardage for touchdowns. He picked up that one long scramble when he came back on the backside, and of course picked up that long one on that quarterback scramble. So he's having a wonderful day.
17-0. Jamie Gill in the locker room having his left shoulder treated. This is not the best scenario, to say the very least, for Texas Tech before this huge home crowd, as they figured might be close to 1,500, 2,000 above capacity of 50,000. So the task for him now is to somehow inflate his Red Raiders again emotionally, because the Aggies have really taken it out of them to this point.
Yes, they need a drive right now. They need to pick up three or four first downs, get that confidence back, perhaps get a score and get back in this football game, or else their emotions are even going to sag even more.
Blackshear will take this one, might as well, down 17-0. And he had a seam up the right side, carries to the 28-yard line. On his first return of 1991, that's one clue as to the slow Red Raiders start this year. Last year's 92-yarder at College Station, first time that had happened in the history of the 12th man coverage team, and he spelled the end of the walk-on coverage team. In fact, with that return, it was also the first touchdown return by an opponent at Kyle Field since Kyle Rote 41 years previous. Anthony Lynn still finding no room whatsoever between the tackles. Pat Henry leading that forward surge along with Mark Wheeler. Wheeler it was that time at nose guard. And that is the end of the first quarter. Aggies 17-0 at the end of one in Lubbock.
Are you dealing with a no down payment insurance agent or a low down payment insurance agent? If so, your premiums can be $200 to $400 higher than they should be, and in some cases even more. Call Kilgone Associates at 872-8572, and they will show you the true bottom line on all your insurance needs. Tell them the guy on TV said to work with you on your initial down payment plan. To save money, call Kilgone Associates today.
It's new, it's hot. Come see what we've got at Fiesta this weekend. Special, so low, so low, so low at Fiesta this weekend.
This weekend at Fiesta, get a 6 1/8 ounce can of Bumblebee tuna for only 39 cents. California large cantaloupe, 69 cents each. And Oscar Mayer Lunchables, only 89 cents. Wow!
Special food at Fiesta weekends.
Get your hands on the one product that will simplify your life. Hands down, it's U.S. Videotel. There are over 150 informative and entertaining programs for the entire family. Additional packages include educational programs for students and Club Vitel for adults. Subscribing is easy and affordable. It starts at just $10 a month. All you need is a phone and an easy-to-use U.S. Videotel terminal or your own PC. Visit one of our mall displays or call U.S. Videotel now at ABC2USV.
We begin the second quarter with the Aggies on top 17-0. We want to alert our viewers that due to atmospheric disturbances called sunspots, we may experience some breakup in the transmission of today's game. This is a temporary condition, so please bear with us. And through the first period, this is going to be all Aggies, 111 rushing yards, 150 total yards, and minus 16 on the ground for the Raiders. That ball from Hall to Hill low, and he caught it on a hop. And that will bring up third and nine. And they have got to find a way to get Hill and Blackshear the ball.
Yes, they do. They've got to throw those quick crossing patterns. They've got to run someone deep to take the secondary back, but run those underneath patterns that don't take a lot of time. Find Blackshear, find Hill out there, and let them use that speed ability to pick up yardage.
That's the gamble they take when they keep everybody in to block and discourage the blitz. There are fewer targets out there for Robert Hall. Fires this one to Hill and knocked away at the last instance by Derek Frazier.
Boy, great play by Frazier that time. That ball was a completed pass, and Frazier came in right on the ball. Instead of playing the man, he played the football and knocked it out of his hands.
Did that better than any Aggie last year. 10 deflections, 4 already this year.
And Bounds this time has the wind with him, if there is any.
Well, he's had some of his best punts this year into the wind. He had a 69-yarder into a 25-mile-an-hour wind in Wyoming. That's just inhuman. And this one takes the side hop out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Transferred from West Texas State when they dropped their program, and the Red Raiders inherited maybe the strongest punting leg in college football. And also one of the most, shall we say, offbeat personalities in college.
How about colorful? How about colorful? You see the green handband there. He said that reminds him to go do certain things. Even wears a green lace on his shoe.
He has some reminders written on his kicking shoe. One says up, up, and away. The other side says boom. Little bit different. Keith McAfee in the game at tailback. He's the senior who was bothered the first couple of games this year by a bad hamstring. Richardson, option keeper, out across the 20-yard line, and they continue to get major gains on first down.
Well, I think if there was any question about Richardson, and as I see him get up, and just as I'm about to say, he looks like he's running well, he gets up limping. He's had that strained arch. He got his foot stepped on, and his foot was actually smashed down in the arch. And he just got up limping. They're going to have to call a timeout. He's going to the sideline.
So neither starting quarterback lasting even well into the second quarter. They are x-raying the left shoulder, by the way, of Jamie Gill. He's been taken to the hospital for that. Richardson can't even make his way to the sideline. Let's watch the end of the play. Brian Dubisky makes the stop. And as Dave mentioned, that right arch already tender, and it looks like he lands right on it.
It looked like Dubisky there, 23, is on his foot. Well, they asked Bucky, they said, Bucky, are you well? He said, hey, a few Advil, a lot of enthusiasm, and I'm back out there playing.
Well, as is the case with Hall, Granger's got some experience. He is only a redshirt freshman, but played much of the LSU game, all of the Tulsa game, and was brilliant in that first half, and then showed some freshman mistakes in the second half as the Hurricane came back and upset the Aggies 35-34. What a marvelously talented left-handed freshman. This is McAfee out of one tackle and fights hard for a first down. Granger's numbers this year, pretty impressive. 5 touchdowns, only 2 interceptions. And in addition to all this, he is a Major League Baseball prospect who Slocum thinks may not last 4 football seasons at A&M, because after his junior baseball season, barring injury, he'll probably be a very high Major League draft pick. Richardson getting tended to. First and 10, McAfee. John Pitts from left end on the tackle. This was 2 plays ago. Watch Granger here.
When he came in, this is a heck of an introduction. I've just come in here, and watch, he comes back, and bam! How do you do there, Mr. Granger? Welcome to the game.
It's Mike Lissio with a personal introduction.
I tell you, I could not believe how good Granger was in that first game that we did. He came in for Richardson in the relief role when Richardson first hurt his foot. I thought he was inhuman with his stats that game.
McAfee out of Saul's tackle, and Lissio finally dragged him down. He'll be close for another first down.
Boy, and A&M's line is just coming off the football. They are controlling the defensive line. Watch them all. Just boom. This is a run play. Guard gets out. He kicks out the outside. The running back cuts up underneath. Look, he's even got one out leading him downfield. They are really coming off the football.
Did you think they give anything up when Hill's not in there? He averages 6.2 per carry. McAfee averages 6.4 per carry.
as his backup. Carter, the fullback, goes nowhere, but a flag is down.
This may be another one of those ones where I think Fred Petty lined up offsides again. Now, he's right by the football. He's got to look down there. You put your hand down there. I played down there. You put your hand down and you look at the football. You want to get as close as you can. You can see his reaction. It's called against him.
And when that happens, there's almost never any question because it's not a matter of movement. It's where that right hand is.
You see his hand down there? We're in front of where the ball is. Now he tries to move back a little bit, but he's still in the neutral zone.
But regardless of how obvious it is, they're always going to hate the call.
Well, I've never seen a defensive lineman offside. It's always the offense pulling the offside.
So first and five. Lone setback is Carter. He'll try the right side. He might have lost a half yard. Wingo pressuring Granger, but still had the agility to reach out and trip up Carter with that right hand. Carter, the brother of San Francisco 49ers nose tackle Michael Carter, hopes one day to play against his brother, maybe with his brother, on the NFL level. He is a junior this year. Major knee surgery himself in 87 and rehabbing through 88. Very limited action the last 2 years for Doug Carter. No flags here. Raiders got back and close for a first down is McAfee. Steve Carr, a converted tight end at strong side inside linebacker on the tackle. And out goes McAfee, along with Harrison and Mitchell, for what will be third and less than one. Extra tight ends, Steve Sagraves and James McKeon, in for the Aggies. Doug Carter, first down midfield.
Boy, and Granger almost pulled them off sides that time with that change in the snap count. When you're a defensive lineman, you've got to, as I say, looking at that football, you see movement, you move. He just about pulled them offside and got the free first down.
Halftime at Auburn with that surprising score holding. Our story, both starting quarterbacks knocked out. Jamie Gill being x-rayed with a left shoulder injury. Bucky Richardson unable to even walk off the field after a foot injury as this series began, and that's why we see Jeff Granger. And the officials want to confer on that sideline over there. Bud Alexander, the referee, will have a word with the Red Raider band director. I would think the subject of cowbells is coming up over there. Whenever you break a huddle, the band, if they're doing their noisemakers, have got to quit at that point.
Right.
Only 1 for 3 through the air. And this is for a team that wanted to be unpredictable today. Does that surprise you?
A little bit, but what you do is you go in with a game plan and all of a sudden you change your game plan because the run is working so well. They've been able to pick up yardage on almost every down. So what you do is you do what is best, and that's run.
Saddle Tramp Spirit Group Protect rattling those cowbells again. No problem for McAfee. A flag is down as McAfee spins near the 40.
Oh, and I think they're going to get holding on A&M this time.
Crew today. Holding it is, and the Aggies will be back in their own territory. It's an awful happy reaction just for a holding penalty.
Well, you gotta look for the positive things. As Spike said, they had to go back to the basics, and this is a basic right here. It's first down, 20 yards to go. The one thing you don't want to do is allow them to pick up a first down and keep that momentum. This is a momentum changer, and Tech needs to stop them here.
Rodney Thomas, true freshman, in for the first time this afternoon. And they'll run the reverse to Thomas. Not what they expected out of that razzle-dazzle. He took the handoff from McAfee and might have picked up one. Mike Licio from left outside linebacker was not fooled. Let's pause briefly for station identification on the Raycom Network.
You're watching 39 KHTV Houston.
Jones Stadium in Lubbock, quite a bit quieter than it was about an hour or so ago, as the Red Raiders find themselves down 17 to nothing, and Jeff Granger will burn the second Texas A&M timeout of the first half. With 9 minutes, 27 seconds remaining in the half, 17-0 Aggies.
Reintroducing a glorious name for a glorious new automobile, the 1992 Buick Roadmaster. With its powerful V8 performance and the security of its driver's airbag, anti-lock brakes, and full perimeter frame, Roadmaster is perhaps the best value in an American luxury sedan. Roadmaster also delivers something only a Buick can deliver. Buick quality.
Turn on excitement. The network of college football's preseason classics. A full season of high-octane Southwest Conference action. Two of the top postseason bowl games. And all winter long, college basketball. For the best in sports, turn on Raycom.
Here's today's game tracer brought to you by the Schick Tracer. Bucky Richardson with a couple of touchdowns, 39 passing, 45 rushing yards. And for Texas Tech, nothing on the ground and Jamie Gill being x-rayed at the hospital. No opportunities for the masked rider to do her thing as her Red Raiders trail 17-0 with 9:27 to play in the first half. Aggies following their timeout have second down at their own 43-yard line. They need the 39 of Texas Tech. And on play action, Granger over the middle for Tony Harrison, and he might go. He will go. A flag down in the Aggie backfield, so this 57-yarder may come back. Yep. And that sigh of relief was from 50,000 Red Raider partisans here.
Well, this was a well-thrown ball. Not the trajectory, but how wide open the receiver was coming across. Fake right there. Granger goes back and sets up. Now, he doesn't throw a clean football. In other words, it doesn't have that perfect spiral. Gets hit late. The ball kind of flutters, but a great catch downfield. There, look at the ball. See the fluttering of the football? It's not pretty, but it's complete. And what a tremendous catch there by Tony Harrison.
Well, I think without the holding, Steve Hoffman, the backup nose tackle, might have been all over Granger. So wipe out the 57-yarder, and A&M all the way back at their 26-yard line. The second and 35. Pressure, and Granger might be flagged for intentional grounding, but they're going to say Rodney Thomas was close enough to the ball.
The This is what Tech has to do to stop this avalanche that's happening to them, and that's get penetration on Granger. This is going to be a screen right there. You see the screen in front? But he doesn't have time. He just has to throw it down in the ground. It's completely broken up by the Tech defense.
Sean Jackson from defensive end is Richardson at least not limping.
Well, I understand. We just got word that he has a sprained toe and may return.
Different from the injury against LSU then. That was the arch. Aggies now out of timeouts. They call their third of the half.
It's tough to get those holes.
On what will be third and half a mile. So we'll take it with them and return after this. Southwest Airlines.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Shining in the Texas sky, the Lone Star is flying high.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
Nuh-uh. A new bath.
Uh-uh. Kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
A deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
Who needs dorm life? It's way too formal. Who needs soda pop that tastes too normal? Who cares about good taste? I know what tastes good. While the best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered.
Hey, give me a Dr. Pepper.
We want it.
Hey, whoa, Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Ordered.
The taste is strange.
Well, it's all A&M so far, but only 2 weeks ago it was all A&M at Tulsa. They had an 18-point lead vanish. Tulsa came back, pulled off one of the biggest upsets of the year, and that is so recently on their minds that you know they're still thinking about it.
Boy, R.C. Slocum said that was the longest third quarter I have ever spent in my life, and I don't want to see that happen again. So you know he has to be thinking about it in a situation where they really seem like they're in total control of a football game.
Crowd hasn't had many opportunities to exercise their lungs, but they do here. And it's Rodney Thomas on the draw play. Only to the 31-yard line. Matt Wingo and Fred Petty got him there.
And Dave, I can tell you what they're saying right now on the Texas Tech sideline. Our defense has held them. Now, offense, get out there and get us some points. If they're able to score before this halftime, they may get back in this football game.
David Davis, walk-on from nearby Loop, not too far from here, where he played six-man football. And Tracy Saul, who the last 2 years has led the Southwest Conference in punt returns, but they've kicked away from him this year, and he has yet to try a return. Fair catch at the 31. He's going to say that he didn't get enough room to make that fair catch. Ramsey Bradbury and Marlon Haynes, he thought, were a little too close. Spike Dykes has been in this situation sometimes this year, but maintaining confidence.
Well, he does have confidence, and I'll tell you, I watched practice yesterday, and his kids had a great bounce about him. He's right when he says there's no quit in him. They're having a tough day. They're behind 17 points. But really, he is a very, very positive person.
What they've missed is the big play this year. Hall on the scramble at the 40, and he got popped helmet to helmet by Jason Atkinson. Marcus Buckley also combining on the tackle, and now Robert Hall is down.
Boy, he got stuck. He was kind of a double tackle, a very clean tackle. It was just the defender came back and just put his hat right on him.
Well, the Red Raiders have depth in the second quarterback spot, but not beyond that. Let's look at what happens.
Well, there's the hit from the side.
That's Buckley who got it.
Yeah, that's Marcus Buckley. Boy, that'll knock the cobwebs out of you. Boy, oh boy. You can see how wobbly he gets up.
The only other Red Raider who has attempted a pass this year is Tracy Saul, the safety. That was on a fake punt situation. So Jason Clemens is the third team quarterback. And you got to think this is the last situation he expected to be in with 8:05 in the first half. And that also takes away quite a few options offensively that Dykes would like to go to. The handoff is to Sheffield, the fullback. Now Clemens is a sophomore from Riswell, New Mexico. And he's not big, 5'11 and 193. Did not letter as a freshman. But at this moment, the last remaining healthy Texas Tech quarterback. Sheffield in motion, first and 10. Clemens right to the air and intended for Blackshear in double coverage. Smith had him deep, Brooms had him short, second and 10.
Well, one of the things that happens with Clemens is that he comes into this football game, he probably hasn't taken any snaps at all during the week because you go with your first and second team quarterback. The cadence is different, everything is different. Now he knows the plays because he's an offensive quarterback, but he just doesn't take any snaps all week.
No doubt he didn't expect to be in this position, neither did the Raiders. He's not in their media gown. On the draw, Anthony Lynn. And that's about his best game today. He's near midfield. Derek Frazier from cornerback on the stop.
Well, one of the things about getting thrown into a situation like this, especially for Clemens, is you don't have time to get worried about it. It's not like they announced him 3 days ago that he's going to step up and be the starter. So you're just standing on the sideline. All of a sudden, the coach says, get in there. So you don't really have time to get all the jitters and think about all the things that might happen to you.
He didn't letter last year because he redshirted. He transferred from Eastern New Mexico, where he played as a freshman. And Texas Tech with a timeout. Clemens to confer on the sideline on what will be a key third and five situation. Ball is up. That's a great sign for Tech.
Every game with an intensity that brings honor to his team, his school, and the very sport itself. Now, you can honor him. Stop at Exxon and vote the best players onto the Exxon Southwest Conference Supreme Team.
Once again, Buick is raising the banner for quality in America. Introducing the 1992 LeSabre. With a higher level of power, safety, security, and convenience. This new LeSabre is going to be one tough act to follow. LeSabre for 1992 from Buick.
She should look happier than that after that fearsome hit delivered by Marcus Buckley. Robert Hall is back in, and that might be why they got that timeout when they did. Let's get Hall in, see what he can do on a key third down from near midfield. Under pressure. Going for Lloyd Hill, picked off but out of bounds by Patrick Bates, who had two interceptions in the opener against LSU. Ball was tipped by Frazier. Bates was right there, but out of bounds, and it'll be fourth down.
The end of the play was he almost came down with this interception. Watch this, a tip from one to the other. Now watch and see if he gets that 1 foot down. Looks like it's on the line.
By a toe. Bounds sails a monster punt through the end zone. 51, but it really covered about 60 plus through the air.
Well, that game is tightened up with NC State and Georgia Tech. Miami, of course, rolling over. There's the Maryland-Pittsburgh early in the first period. Maryland ahead of Pittsburgh.
Red Raiders just got good news with the return of Hall. The Aggies get good news as Bucky Richardson's back in, so he will try to go with that sprained toe. 6:42, first half, 17-0 A&M. Hill the lone setback. Hog collared by Wingo. That's about as impressive a one-handed grab as you're going to see by a linebacker.
If he doesn't get that, Hill is down the sidelines for about another 10, 15 yards. But Wingo is really the spirit of this defense. He's got 60 tackles coming into this game. He is just all over the field. He's a great center fielder on that linebacking core, just has great range.
Cliff Gross checks in, the true freshman from A&M Consolidated. In that offset eye, and Mitchell in motion. Greg Hill. Ankle tackled by Harry Dias, the left end, transfer from Hutchinson Community College in Kansas. And for one of the rare times here in the first half, the Aggies will have third and more than a foot or two. They need five here.
Well, you get the feeling that really the Tech defense is starting to get its composure back. The offense has not. They've not been able to move with any consistency. But this defensive unit, as Spike said, there's no quitting these young men.
On the blitz, Wingo. On the catch, the tight end, Greg Short. And Brian Dubisky right there on Short, big 6'3", 230-pound sophomore.
Dave, this is a tight end delay. What happens is the tight end stands on the line and acts as if he's blocking. As the quarterback drops back, the tight end comes off the line. He delays, comes across, and picks up a big first down.
And as you saw, they have four times the first downs the Tech has managed here in the half. Greg Hill, by the standards of this first two periods, that's about as well as they've defended him, and he still picks up four or five on first down. Among the conference rushing leaders, you got Cobb, who leads the nation, better than 216 per game. Then you got Hill at 135. He's eighth in the nation. And Anthony Lynn, well down the list after being a top five rusher last year, has much more to do with his blocking than with his own running, according to the Tech coaches. And Hill well on his way to another 100-yard day. He'll go right out of the block of Short, who went in motion. Dubisky wrapping him up as he reaches the 40. It'll be third and about one.
That's the way you have to defend Hill. You have to make him run to the sidelines. Don't allow him to get that cutback and come up. And he comes up limping a little bit.
Boy, this has just been an endless procession of limp-offs all day. McAfee replacing Hill. Two tight ends. Carter the fullback. Close and appears to have the first down. As they unpilot at the 42, first down A&M. What has Tech gained by going from the 4-3 to the 3-4 this year?
Well, one of the things that caused them to go to this 34 defense is the lack of big linemen. They did not have those four big 6'4", 275-pound linemen. They felt they had a lot more speed at the linebacker position, which could make up for that lack of size.
Got a half size to play this A&M running attack. Carter to the 49. So this is one of the few teams where the 3-4 really isn't the best design defense. It's great against the run and shoot people, but it's tough against such a running attack.
Absolutely. It really is tough. If you don't have those linebackers that will step up in the hole, and they have good size in the 225 range, you've got problems.
North Carolina State had given up 10 points total this year before this game. Georgia Tech has hit them for 21. Nothing fancy. McAfee, no gain here. Good forward surge, and it'll be third and probably still about four as we go inside the 2.5 minute mark. Brad Phelps, the right end, first man to hit Keith McAfee. The A&M attack, which, as we said at the outset, wanted to mix it up, finding no need to mix it up.
No, they're just going with that power run play. They pick up that 5-6 yards on first down. They're just keeping Tech off balance all the time.
Option Richardson for the first down and a lot more. Out at the 35 after a pickup of 16.
Well, we talked a lot about Matt Wingo and his great speed down the line, but little Brian Mitchell, 180 pounds, he knocks him off the play. That allows Richardson to get outside.
And from those numbers, the toe must feel okay.
Well, I'm sure it still hurts, but you're right. He's such a competitor. I saw where R.C. Slocum said, I wouldn't trade him for anybody. That's the kind of leader he is on our team.
Does well to get one or maybe two. Wingo got into the backfield. Steve Carr, the man bringing down McAfee. And that is plenty of time for this drive to continue. However, remember that the Aggies have used all their timeouts, and they're only now close to field goal range. Where they are right now, they'd be kicking from 50, 51 yards. They need at least another 10, and of course they'd like a lot more than that. Richardson on second and 9, going deep, has his man at the 5-yard line, Brian Mitchell. First and goal.
Two amazing things on this. First of all, Richardson unable to step forward and deliver the ball. He really threw it off his back heel and just threw it as hard as he could, allowed Brian Mitchell to run underneath it. Watch the point I'm trying to make with Richardson. You want to step forward on a pass like this, but he kind of falls back. He has pressure on his feet. He just throws it out there and lets Mitchell use that great speed to the sideline. Good concentration. Bam, they're down inside the 10-yard line.
That's not a bad toss by a running, quote-unquote, quarterback. That was letter perfect. Randy Simmons is into the backfield. Richardson on the roll for the touchdown.
Bucky Richardson was a director on that last play.
And what a difference that makes. 17-0 bad enough. Now you've got zero momentum. And you're down 23 and maybe 24-0 at halftime unless they can do something in the last minute five. The Bucky Richardson Show this afternoon in Lubbock. Venetulius, perfect today.
Well, as we sit and see Bucky take a rest, watch here again. Watch Bucky start telling, you go over here and look, you go that way, get over there.
Says you're a senior, you know
right.
This. Get over there.
Now, Keith, this is a weak side play, and I'm running it. And there he is, scrambling to the end zone. So sure doesn't look like that toe hurts. He gets those feet just inside.
And he had McKeon open in the back of the end zone, but went the safe route for his third touchdown. On the ground here in the half. Coming up at halftime, test your knowledge of the Southwest Conference with the Southwest Airlines Trivia Tester. We'll also visit with new Tech basketball coach James Dickey and meet this week's classroom champion. We will also kick off balloting for the Exxon Supreme team with a check presentation to the Southwest Conference Scholarship Fund. All this and more in about a minute and 5 seconds coming up at halftime. And Atulius with absolutely no wind whatsoever will kick to either Donald Marshall or Rodney Blackshear. From the 17, it's Dubisky on the return with an alley. And out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Plenty of time, 59 seconds, and the Red Raiders have got to get something here.
Boy, that was a nice run by Dubisky. Made a good move once he caught the ball. He's the up back for blocking purposes. He makes a nice move here, cuts back up inside, and now gets back outside. And they've got probably their best field position in a long while in this game.
12-play drive. Again, capped by Richardson scoring. And Robert Hall, with all day, settles short for Lynn. Ankle tackle, and he'll lose about four. Red Raiders, with 49 seconds remaining, will burn their second timeout.
In that situation, Dave, you have got to go downfield. That little short dump pass out to the flat isn't going to get you anything, especially with the speed of these A&M linebackers. They recover so quickly. You've got to go 15, 18 yards downfield, crossing patterns, see if you can beat them one-on-one deep. But you've got to make something happen in this situation. Down 24 to nothing.
Well, so often recently, we've come out here, we've seen one of the best scoring attacks in the country. This is the first time, in fact, in 5 years, that the Tech offense has been held below 20 points for three consecutive games. That's just not what Dykes' attack has been about recently. That's one reason he shuffled the offensive line this week. They have missed the big play. They've had only one play of 40 or more yards, and that was last week, Gill to Hill for 48. And last year, the year before that, they were all about big plays. So when you take that out of their attack, it's just not the same Tech offense. Hill flushed out. He'll be dropped inside the 40. He might have dropped the ball. Sam Adams on the sack. And still Tech ball with 41 seconds in the half.
Well, his pocket just collapses on here. He has nowhere to go. You see Sam Adams reach across and just strip that ball out.
The alert Red Raider was the center, Scott Fitzgerald. Ball audibilizing. Third and a bunch, and his receiver fell down, Lloyd Hill. So with 32 seconds to go, fourth and 17. And that's too much time to consider going for it on your own end of the field.
No, you don't go for it in this situation. You punt the ball away. But if you're Texas A&M, you may put a rush on because obviously you're not going to have enough time with no timeouts to drive the length of the field, so why not rush it?
And Bounds is going to love this situation because he just airs this one out. All the way to the lip of the cup. 58 yards before Brian Tucker caught up to it. Mark Bounds will improve what is already a conference-leading net average. Now that's net. Most punters would settle for 41 gross.
Gross.
That is phenomenal. Half. Boy, Mark Bounds averaged today up to 52 per kick.
I'll tell you, we may have a lot of punters wearing those little green armbands and writing on their shoes after this game.
Richardson will settle for a 24-0 halftime advantage. Well, this is certainly going against the grain of the recent history of this series in Lubbock. No game in the last six meetings in this stadium decided by more than 6 points. And we've still got a half of football to go, but a 24-0 A&M lead. And if you're Spike Dykes, where do you start your halftime talk?
Well, I think the first thing you have to do is kind of rally your troops around your new quarterback, saying, guys, listen, we're going to be embarrassed terribly in this football game. We need to rally. We need to start back with the basics, get something positive happening. Defense, you're not doing that bad. But we have got to answer.
Lucky Richardson with three touchdown runs and a Ventatulius field goal, and it's 24-0 at halftime. Southwest Conference Football on Raycom is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by Budweiser, by Norwegian Cruise Line, by Exxon, by Buick, and drive safely. Don't wreck your life.
Buying a new car involves some difficult decisions.
Okay, let's see. Four-door? Not two-door. Hey, maybe no doors.
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Well, you gotta be kidding.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist.
Way too fast.
Then move on to the really difficult decisions.
Okay, red. No, blue. Maybe white.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Two-tone?
The Loan Source.
If your face were square, shaving would be simple. If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Shining in the Texas sky, the Lone Star.
I burn with desire each time my heart fans the fire to that old flame that burns inside of me. There's nobody in his right mind would have left her, even my heart.
Bud Light proudly presents George Strait, Country Music's Entertainer of the Year.
At Texas A&M, I've been given the opportunity to work on real projects that aren't just for a grade. I'm gaining great experience.
Experience is important in and out of the classroom. Our physics students are hunting new particles at the supercollider and building satellite technology at Texas A&M.
Texas A&M University has been demonstrating its commitment to education for over 115 years. Soon, we'll be the proud host of the nation's newest presidential library.
Texas A&M University, a leader in education in and out of the classroom.
Here in Lubbock, Texas, Texas A&M leading 24-0 over Tech. Let's go down to the field. Texas Aggie Band.
That taste to know.
No, no.
Who cares about good taste? I know what tastes good.
While
the best thing's always so misunderstood.
Oh.
Just give me what the doctor ordered. Just what the doctor ordered.
Hey, give me a Dr. Pepper. We want it.
Hey, whoa, Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Ordered.
The taste of strange.
Why Farm Bureau Insurance?
Our agent helps us get the right coverage,
so we're always protected.
When you have a claim, Farm Bureau works hard to help you get things back to normal.
They can help you with a plan to make your retirement years great years.
Helping you is what we do best. That's why people across America, from every walk of life, depend on Farm Bureau Insurance.
America's like you.
And you don't even have to be a farmer. Just smart.
So, we put in this new heat pump, and our bills are really...
down?
Exactly.
Must be a Lennox.
Get up to $750 in U.S. savings bonds with the purchase of selected Lennox equipment.
Every day, the trained professionals at Hallmark Air Conditioning help another home or business stay comfortable. Shouldn't Hallmark serve your comfort needs? Open 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. 7 days a week. Hallmark Air Conditioning, your quality Lennox dealership.
Attaboy, Dave.
Hi, I'm John Sanders. I went to Sweeney Jewelers and bought a diamond solitaire ring for over $700 with discount. To show you the difference, my diamond ring, exactly the same size and quality, is $275. This diamond ring is not last year's model or difference in style. It's the same diamond ring for only for a lot less money. You can use the difference for your honeymoon or any special occasion. Remember, you can go to Sweeney's and pay big time or call Jay Sanders for that appointment.
Time now for the Southwest Conference Football Trivia Tester, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Name the first Texas Tech football player to play in the NFL and send your answer to Southwest Airlines Trivia Tester, 1300 West Mockingbird Lane, Suite 501, Dallas 75247. You'll be eligible to win two round-trip tickets anywhere in the states of Texas and Arkansas, courtesy of Southwest Airlines, celebrating 20 years of loving you. You'll also receive two tickets to an upcoming conference game. Answers have to be received by Thursday, and you must be 18 or older to win. Here's the answer to last week's Southwest Airlines Trivia Tester, the only Southwest Conference offensive back to achieve consensus All-America status three times was Doak Walker of SMU. And our congratulations to Bill Martin of Moody, who is this week's winner. 24-0 A&M at halftime, and unhappy momentarily at least, Red Raider backer is the new head coach of Red Raider basketball, James Dickey, and we appreciate your spending some time with us today. After 1 year as an assistant, but many years under Eddie Sutton as an assistant both at Arkansas and at Kentucky, will we see a Sutton-like system installed here?
Certainly it'll be similar, Dave. We're really excited about the opportunity, and a lot of the philosophy that I've developed over the years will come from Coach Sutton, especially defensively. Offensively, we hope to speed the tempo of the game up, incorporate some three-point shooting into our system.
Are you on a 3-4-5-year plan? How long do you think it'll take you before you have both the talent here and the system in place?
Well, we want to be competitive right away. Obviously, we need to do a good job in recruiting. We want to upgrade our schedule. And we need to get our fans excited about Red Raider basketball again. But we hope that we can be competitive this season. The conference is going to be very balanced, very tough, and our non-conference schedule is going to be too tough for our team and for a new system, but we're certainly looking forward to the opportunity.
And I guess your best news at this point is that Will Flemons looks good after his surgery.
That's correct, Dave. Will has really done great in his rehabilitation. We expect him to be at full speed on October the 15th.
Thanks for coming by, and we'll look forward to basketball season
with
you.
Thank you,
Dave. That's James Dickey, new Red Raider head basketball coach, 24-0 Aggies, and we have more here at halftime after this.
Once again, Buick is raising the banner for quality in America. Introducing the 1992 LeSabre. With a higher level of power, safety, security, and convenience. This new LeSabre is going to be one tough act to follow. LeSabre for 1992 from Buick.
For over 25 years, the National Association of Collegiate Directors of Athletics has brought the team concept to athletic administration. Over 3,000 dedicated professionals helping each other to balance budgets, raise funds, manage current issues, and more. Plus, the NACTA Foundation provides drug education, as well as scholarship grants and internships for student athletes. Academic responsibility, athletic excellence. That's the National Association of Collegiate Directors of Athletics.
Again, 6, 7, 8.
After making it on Broadway, some of the finest entertainers around go off Broadway. They appear on Norwegian Cruise Line. No other cruise line offers such entertainment. Norwegian Cruise Line, the best vacation you've ever had. Plus...
The Exxon Southwest Conference Player of the Week is Trevor Cobb of Rice. The junior running back gained 240 yards on an amazing 42 carries against Iowa State. After three games, he leads the nation in rushing with a 216-yard average. For being Player of the Week, Exxon will donate $1,000 in Trevor Cobb's name to the Southwest Conference Scholarship Fund.
Great players and great teams are constant in the 77-year history of the Southwest Conference. Last year, over 2 million fans saw an offensive explosion as Southwest Conference teams set 22 national records. This fall, four schools are ranked in the top 25. And again, the conference boasts exceptional candidates for college football's highest honors. Call the Southwest Conference ticket hotline now, 1-800-800-SWC-8.
It was the night after a game. I wanted to celebrate. So I went out and had some beers. No big deal. I felt okay. I was driving slow. It was a breath test I had a problem with. Cops took me in. I lost my license. I'm off the team. Everybody's all over me. I wish I'd thought of this before.
...24-0 Aggies at halftime. This fall marks the first year of the Exxon Southwest Conference Supreme Team, an official all-conference team determined by the vote of the fans. Now, in addition, the Supreme Team program also provides significant scholarship funds for the Southwest Conference. Last Saturday at SMU, 300 Exxon retailers gathered for a check presentation to Southwest Conference Commissioner Fred Jacoby.
Hello, everyone. I'm John Adkins, Western Region Manager for the retail business for Exxon. Today marks the beginning of balloting for the Exxon Southwest Conference Supreme Team. Fans throughout the Southwest Conference will be able to go to the neighborhood Exxon station over the next 30 days and cast a vote for the players that they think are the best in the conference. We've got plenty of ballots. There's no purchase necessary. It should be a lot of fun, so I encourage all the fans to go out and vote. But this program is more than just recognizing athletic accomplishments. It's also about academics and it's about scholarships. I have with me today over 300 Exxon dealers and distributors from throughout the Southwest Conference who represent over 1,000 Exxon retailers who have contributed their funds to a scholarship fund for the Southwest Conference. I'd like to introduce now Bill Smith and Frank Marino.
Thanks, John. On behalf of the Exxon retailers, we're very excited about supporting the Southwest Conference.
On behalf of Exxon, its dealers and distributors, we are delighted to present a check for $51,400 to Commissioner Fred Jacoby and the Southwest Conference.
Thank you very much, Frank. The Southwest Conference is very appreciative of the significant and meaningful contribution that Exxon is making to our intercollegiate athletics and academic programs. We're extremely grateful and pleased to be with you.
Aggies 24, Red Raiders nothing. As the going band from Raiderland entertains on the field at Jones Stadium, and I don't think the Aggies, and I definitely don't think the Red Raiders expected this type of halftime dominance.
I tell you, I did not expect it, but there's an old cliche, and it has been used today. It is all Aggies.
Well, they have passed sparingly, but very effectively in the first half.
Now, Richardson makes a nice pass across the middle to pick up Mitchell, and Mitchell gets almost down to the goal line.
And that's been really, that was about the only pass that they threw in the first half. It's been all running game other than that.
That set up the early Bucky Richardson touchdown keeper. Now, Jamie Gill didn't last long at all today. You're going to see him chased and dropped. And that's about 470 combined pounds between Sam Adams and his own 210 pounds on that left shoulder.
And one of the problems that Tech has had all year is that they sink, and they really have sunk after this injury to Jamie Gill, their leader.
Bucky Richardson with all three touchdowns on short keepers. A nice scramble here.
Yeah, he scrambles back weak side and picks up nice yardage. That was one of the things that A&M wanted to utilize. They wanted to utilize Bucky Richardson's great scrambling ability. They've been able to do it on third downs, and just about any passing situation.
So the number 23 Aggies on top as we check the Budweiser Top 10 report later on. A big one between number 10 and number 1 in Tallahassee. Number 2 Miami rolling over Oklahoma State. Number 3 Washington later on will play host to Arizona.
Tennessee is idle this week. Oklahoma and Iowa State. Iowa State ahead 3-0 in the first period. And Clemson, Georgia will be later tonight.
7-9 in a game that lately has always decided who would go to the Rose Bowl for the Big Ten. And number 8 Notre Dame later tonight at Stanford. And that is our Budweiser Top 10 report.
For the best in sports, turn on Raycom.
Buying a new car involves some difficult decisions.
Okay, let's see. Four-door? Not two-door.
Hey, maybe no doors. At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Well, you gotta be kidding.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist.
Way too fast.
Then move on to the really difficult decisions.
Okay, red. No, blue. Maybe white.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Two-tone?
The Loan Source.
I've always been interested in science, biology, chemistry, physics. They were all fascinating. In college, I discovered ways to apply the pure sciences to medicine, exploring new ways to help the body repair itself. The Texas Tech Health Sciences Center has introduced me to a whole new world of opportunity.
It comes from within. Really, I mean, because a lot of times there's not going to be somebody there to push, you know, like study harder or study longer or you know, do that kind of thing. I think you have to do that and want to succeed. You have to have a desire to do so.
Texas Tech offensive tackle Stacy Patrick says that his parents play a major role in his success on the field and in the classroom.
They've been real supportive of me and they've never put pressure on me. You know, just do your best is all they've ever asked, and that's what I try to do all the time. And they've supported me 100% in everything I do.
Aggies are dominant on the scoreboard and in the stats, and boy, these are some ugly numbers offensively for Texas Tech. Only 26 total yards.
And Tech realized that they had to be able to run the football, and you see the results of their running in the first half, minus 2 yards.
A&M keeps it better than 20 minutes. They lead by 24. We'll be ready for the start of the second half in a moment.
Reintroducing a glorious name for a glorious new automobile, the 1992 Buick Roadmaster. With its powerful V8 performance and the security of its driver's airbag, anti-lock brakes, and full perimeter frame, Roadmaster is perhaps the best value in an American luxury sedan. Roadmaster also delivers something only a Buick can deliver. Buick quality.
Most of my friends don't know what they're going to do after graduation, but I've already locked in guaranteed skill training in the Army. Qualify now and you can reserve even the Army's most sought-after technical training up to 12 months in advance through the Army's delayed entry program. Sure, being a soldier won't be easy, but then nothing worth having ever is.
Driving after a few drinks is crazy. Don't wreck your life.
Southwest Conference Football on Raycom is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by Texas Farm Bureau, by Ship Tracer, and by Coors Light. On the South Plains of Lubbock, Lynn Elliott, 9 yards deep to Rodney Thomas. And to start the second half, it'll be A&M from their 20. They lead 24-0. The Aggie drive chart in the first half will show dominant ball control. 8 plays for a field goal, 6, 7, and 12-yard touchdown drives.
Really only stopped one time. Forced the punt once.
And Bucky Richardson out momentarily in the first half with a sprained toe, averaging right at 8 yards per carry with 3 running touchdowns. Tailback Greg Hill squirting between the tackles for 4 on first down. Ben Kirkpatrick, junior linebacker from Post here in West Texas, on the tackle. Hill was pretty much first, second, and third option in their ground game until today, and now they can finally start to do with Richardson what was the plan all along, and they were unable to do because of his first game injury. And that is compliment Hill by letting Richardson scramble, run some quarterback draws, and especially let him go on the option keepers. Hill around end for the first down. Dubisky meets him at the 34, and the Aggies pick up right where they left off in the first half.
Well, they open up those huge holes. When you have a running back with the vision of a Greg Hill, you can see that backside hole. He slices through it, picks up that huge yardage. Here, slide to the right now. See that backside hole? Bam, right through it. And he never breaks stride. He doesn't have to slow down to slide around someone. He just accelerates through it.
A&M per carry, better than 5 yards today. Tech, less than 2 yards per carry. Greg Hill again, 2, maybe 3, ball loose, but after the whistle, he had been downed already by Kevin Jackson, the backup right defensive end. Kevin, a senior from Midland Lee, former walk-on. That's really been a victory for the Tech defense when they limit anybody to 2 or 3 yards. A&M had a lot of third and ones, a lot of second and twos. Second and 8 here. On play action, Richardson airing it out for Mitchell and perfectly defended by Anthony Riley, the sophomore corner from Richardson.
They have a little play fake action into the line, trying to hold the backers in that secondary. But Wiley was not fooled. He ran stride for stride with Mitchell. Here's the play fake into the line. That's supposed to hold the linebackers. Now Richardson just throws this as far as he can for Mitchell. But Wiley with just excellent coverage. One-on-one coverage. Good position, knocks the ball down. Can't play it any better than that.
Third and a long 7 over the middle for Ryan Matthews. And one of the legion of freshmen for A&M out of Houston Lamar with the first down gainer. And that just breaks the back emotionally of that defense.
Oh, it does. Richardson had time to stand back there and find his receiver cutting across the middle. He got hit late, but he really threw a strike. You know, it's interesting. Everybody says he's the running quarterback. Granger is the quarterback. There's the hit afterwards that Bucky Richardson took. But Granger's supposed to be the pure passer and Richardson the pure runner.
Well, he was Holiday Bowl MVP last year, and as much for his passing as for his running. Hill inside the 40 on first down. At least 34 points in each of their first 3 games for the first time in 13 years. Came in with a conference leading average of just under 38 points per game. on pace to improve on that. And this, keep in mind, with a team that out of 86 scholarship players has 63 freshmen and sophomores. Has there ever been a ranked team with that much youth? Doug Carter, maybe one. Bring up third and again, six or seven. The A&M Musts, we'll get a chance to review here. They came in wanting to make Tech predictable, be unpredictable themselves, and unleash Richardson and straight A's in the first half.
Oh, they've got an A plus on Richardson because they did unleash his ability to scramble, so they have done everything and have done it extremely well.
A new twist this week. Short went in motion. Richardson still with it after a nice fake. Great catch. Close to the first down at the 33 by the second tight end, James McKeon. The true freshman from Willis, Texas, with his second catch of the year. And a whole bunch of scores to run by you. Georgia Tech still by one. Miami still rolling. Auburn still trailing at home by seven. So far, the surprise of the day. Underway in Austin, scoreless second quarter. A Texas offense still with only one touchdown this year, and they do measure for the A&M first down. Alabama trailing early. Tennessee, Chattanooga. Not Tennessee. Tennessee, Chattanooga. Word from the hospital on Jamie Gill, deep bruise on the left shoulder, will not return today, but really that's good news because they had to really be fearful of a break with as much pressure as landed on that left shoulder. Hill off tackle to the 30. Mike Lissio on the tackle.
And if I'm Texas A&M in this situation, and I'm R.C. Slocum standing over there, I've got to just say, hey, this is smash face football. This is just big man on big man. Let's just run the football down. Here's a little swinging gate.
They ran it to Rodney Thomas in the opener. They run it to Greg Hill here. Flag down, touchdown, maybe. And they're two for two on the swing.
Well, they may have been too quick for their team and too quick for us. Look at Richardson. What do you mean?
But Alexander says they were too quick for themselves, even. And you can't run that play all that often, so when you run it, you better be flawless. They've shown it twice this year. Do you think anybody won't be ready for that the rest of the year?
See, that puts pressure on the team preparing. Because you gotta, it's just something else that you have to prepare for. Watch out for the swinging gate. Even if they don't use it, it puts pressure on the teams that they're going to play. That's good. Bucky Richardson over there saying, now look, ref, what did you see? What kind of motion did you see?
Well, enough, evidently. That's two touchdowns they've had brought back after penalties. The Aggie offense, 218 total or rushing yards today, 316 total yards today. McAfee, the tailback, on the fake from Richardson. And again, he finds his tight end short. Boy, he met Tracy Saul head-to-head and finished off a 22-yard pickup. And I'm a little surprised that Saul is back on his feet.
I want to tell you one thing. I could hear that in the press box, and we've got to be 75 yards from the field. Tracy Saul. Boy, did he come over and stick him. Short makes a nice catch away. Look how far he had to reach out. Now watch Tracy Saul come into your picture, number six. Right there, bam. Boy, that's given everything.
First, I thought it was helmet to helmet. Luckily for Saul, it was shoulder rather than helmet, accepting that blow. First down, Rodney Thomas inside the 10. And then driven back by Steve Carr. They have such depth at running back. True freshman Thomas, redshirt freshman Hill, true freshman Gross, Carter is a junior. Simmons and McAfee are seniors. And we have seen them all today. And we're seeing another long drive. Thomas. Good backward surge that time. And bring up third down and still about seven needed. Let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the Raycom Network.
You're watching 39 KHTV Houston.
Jones Stadium, SRO today, better than 50,000. On a perfect day weather-wise, if not scoreboard-wise. Hill and Carter in, third and seven. And too tall for the intended receiver, Brian Mitchell, in the corner, bring up a field goal situation on fourth down. That's one of the few imperfect passes thrown by Richardson today.
That was just a timing pass to the back corner. The defensive back never has a chance to look back. And had he thrown a strike, it was a touchdown, but he just overthrew it just a little bit.
Benatulli is already with one field goal today and for the year 4 for 5. This one will be right at 27 yards. And right on. 8:51 in the third. The Aggies add to their lead, and they have the Raiders down by 27 here in Lubbock.
In the art of making beer, no one has explored the essence of refreshment like Coors. And now we've discovered a way to double chill a beer, to lock in the refreshing dry cold of the Rockies. The result is a unique cold sensation and a finish as clean as ice. Introducing Double Chilled Coors Dry. Only Coors does it. Coors Dry has it. Cold from the start, clean to the finish. Coors Dry. Feel the chill.
Why Farm Bureau Insurance?
They look at your total insurance needs
and develop what's best for you.
When you have a claim, Farm Bureau works hard to get you back on the road fast.
If health problems interrupt your income, they can help keep you going.
Helping you is what we do best. That's why people across America, from every walk of life, depend on Farm Bureau Insurance. Americans
like you. You don't even have to be a farmer. Just smart.
If your face were square, shaving would be simple. If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
Well, 14 years ago, the largest crowd in Jones Stadium history, as the Aggies visited before 55,000 then, about 5,000 stood. Paid attendance today, 50,577. And all the way around the stadium, they are standing. They like Spike, and they don't mind those spikes at Jones Stadium. One of the top crowds ever. Most of them still here and still hoping for the Raider offense to get something going. They'll have to kick this one again. And while they do, let's look at the Texas Tech first half possession chart. Not much to look at.
Well, they're going to be short. Boy, oh boy. That's just no consistency. The only consistency as they had is they worked their punter a lot.
Slocum, before the game, said that what they do so well is make you think pass and run defensively every play. And when you're that unsure, you usually can't defend either one very well. That hadn't been the case today.
No, they've been very predictable because they haven't made anything on that first down. They've come up second at 9 yards plus. They've had to pass every second and third down with any hope to pick up a first down. They just have not had it.
Red Raiders are going to turn down the penalty. And they'll take it at their 35-yard line. Their musts coming into today. They don't want to allow big plays.
Well, they haven't really allowed big plays. They've had one. Strike early and hang close. They've been, boy, they were just rocked early. Begin, be opportunistic. That's an incomplete because really when you lose your quarterback, you lose so much.
Robert Hall most of the way and into Aggie territory at the 43-yard line is Byron Hooper. Their senior possession receiver from San Antonio Clark, good for 22.
And Hall finally gets some time to pass here and throws a nice strike to Hooper. Little curl-in pattern in the seam. Hooper picks up great field position for them. They've got to be happy to be across the 50-yard line.
Three wideouts left. Hall looking that way. Floats it deep for Stinnett. Too deep and almost picked off by Frazier. First down, they went for the possession receiver. Second down, they go for their best speedster, Stinnett, who has been held without a catch today.
Well, that's the kind of play when you want to lead him across the middle. He's out there one and one. The defensive back has got the backside of him. You want to lead him inside. Don't overthrow it.
Blackshear without a catch. Stinnett without a catch. Anthony Lynn. Might manage the 42, and again, they're back in a predictable third long passing situation.
Pat Hendry's again getting that great penetration in there. Before he can even get to the line to the hole, they're getting that backside penetration and just breaking everything up.
Horns on the board as they try to keep their 25-year winning streak going against Rice. Ball caught at the 26 by Hill. They have found Lloyd Hill twice today. He's been their best target.
And that may be the best pass that Robert Hall has made. He's under pressure. He has to throw off his back foot, but he throws a beautiful ball. That's what they needed more of in the first half.
That's a great matchup. Hill, the high school All-American, and Kevin Smith, the probable All-American as a senior this year. Ball flushed out. Flag down, two flags. As he manages the 22, Lance Tackleman, the right end on the tackle.
Well, there's one flag right in the pile, and then there's one downfield that was thrown from one of the back judges. This may be two separate penalties.
I think it was, because there was enough time between the flags.
It's probably going to be holding on one on the offensive line, and then maybe holding in the secondary on the defense.
But Alexander has the word.
Ooh, yeah.
And Bud's mic inoperable today.
Well, I think it's an illegal hit, and he grabbed the face mask downfield on the defense.
And I think they also said, well, they may have changed their mind.
You may hear it again.
Illegal participation was the first call.
That's the face mask. That's declined. That's the 12 men. That's illegal participation.
That's not what they mean by the 12 man tradition. That's the penalty they take down to the 12-yard line. Best chance today by the Red Raiders. Lynn inside the 10, and he did it all on his own. There are just not any holes there. At the conclusion of today's game, Dave and I will announce the Southwest Airlines player of the game. Many candidates today, all wearing the maroon and white. Second and 8, they need the 2. And he fumbles the snap, falls on it, loses one. It'll be 3rd and 9.
I think that's a good example of exactly what Spike Dyke said. We are unopportunistic. We just do not come down there and capitalize when we get situations. You can't waste a down in this situation.
Good protection. Deep. Knocked away. Intended for Mike Honeycutt in the corner of the end zone. And Kerry Vincent had the coverage.
Well, you're going to see a great recovery by Vincent. He just got a hand out and tipped the ball away. Receiver is wide open. You'll see Vincent come in there. Just get a hand in there. Just tap that ball away.
So that fumbled snap really costs Texas Tech. And Lynn Elliott, who is 8 for 11 this year, one of the top kickers in the nation, 27-yarder good, maybe, as again, flags are down.
Well, if they're going to be offsides, and I think it's going to be against A&M offsides, that'll bring up fourth down and about maybe 4 yards to go.
But do you take points off the board if you're Spike Dykes and you have no points until this Elliott field goal?
If you're down 27 to nothing, you might as well. I know you're hunting for respectability and you don't ever take, supposedly you're not supposed to take points off the scoreboard, but I think I would in this situation.
Well, Robert Hall back out there, and Elliott back on the sideline, so they're taking him off. They're taking the penalty.
But one of the things Hall needs to do is switch up his snap count. He's been walking up to the line real slowly and going on first sound. He needs to walk up there and go on the second sound and emphasize that first sound and maybe get him driving, bring him off sides.
Fade pattern and a flag. Frazier interfering with Lloyd Hill, and the gamble works.
And Frazier was saying he had my jersey. The first thing Frazier did, get up, he just grabbed his jersey and said he had my jersey. Perhaps we can see in the back of the jersey there, at the back of the picture, there was what Frazier was saying. Hey, he had my jersey, but...
No, Lloyd Hill did not have anybody's jersey.
No.
Convincing act by Frazier, first and goal. And it's Sheffield, the fullback, touchdown Tech.
I'll tell you one thing, he did not make it by much. The official on the side saw the penetration across the line. He ran in and called it immediately, but he didn't make it by very much.
So 27-6 with lots of time left, 6:09 in the third. Elliott has a school record 58 consecutive extra points and make it 59 in a row. But a flag down again. And it's the Red Raiders clapping, and again, 12 men on the field for A&M. They're really taking that tradition a little too literally today. I don't think they'll take this point off the board and make it 27-7 A&M. Illegal participation. Extra point good.
They'll assess the penalty for 12th man. They'll assess that on the kickoff. There's Atkinson flying over top. You can see the penetration there. Boy, he didn't get very much in there, but he penetrated the line.
He got enough, and the Red Raiders are on the board. We're back after this from Southwest Airlines.
Ever since Southwest Airlines introduced our Friends Fly Free sale, people have gotten friendlier.
Sugar Plum, your favorite pillow.
If you make reservations and buy your round-trip ticket at our regular low unrestricted fare by October 31st, a friend gets to fly with you this fall, free.
Hey, Dad, seen the hedge trimmer?
You and a friend can travel through January 6th.
Here's that putter I borrowed last year, oh, buddy.
Southwest Airlines Friends Fly Free sale. It's great for your pocketbook and your popularity.
I can't tell you how it feels when you're way out there on your own tracking the bad guys. How it feels leading a skilled team that's the eyes and ears of the whole outfit. When all your training is coming alive. But finding those tanks and telling the air cavalry right where to hit them? I can tell you exactly how that feels.
What's in is out, what's out is in. If you don't know well, where on earth have you been?
Yeah.
Don't try to sell me, I know what tastes good.
We know
while
it.
The best thing's always so misunderstood. Just give me what the doctor ordered.
Dr. Pepper.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Hey, give me a Dr. Pepper. We want it.
Hey,
whoa,
Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Order.
The taste of sweet
Dr. Pepper. We love it.
Raiders on the board, and Lynn Elliott set up for an onside kick, and he doesn't care who knows it.
This
that ball
is
lying flat on its side at midfield after the mark off for 12 men on the field on the extra point. Wants the high bounce, gets it. Red Raider recovery at the 35-yard line. Scotty Allen caught the big hop. And that's the way you kick onside. That was absolute perfection.
If you could not take and draw up this play better than what they have just executed it. He stood the whole time there during the timeout, right exactly poised like that. Now watch the big high bounce right there. Now it's like a jump ball in basketball. Everybody goes up, and you see those two black shirts come down with it.
Boy, has the atmosphere in this ballpark changed. Overthrown for Sheffield. And if Atkinson had looked up, he would have had a free interception. And a flag down at the 17-yard line, well away from the play. That's where Lloyd Hill ran his pattern. Was there interference again? He was certainly not going to be involved in the play.
I'm wondering whether R.C. Slocum will ever want to play a third quarter after that third quarter at Tulsa. And now the start of this third quarter, or the continuation of this third quarter.
Personal foul, Frazier, who just got tagged for interference in the end zone. And again, looks mystified. 10 A&M penalties. That's their only major letdown today, is in that category.
And that's been the best offense that Tech has had today, is that old yellow flag. Boy, if they score here, they're only down.
They're down 13 if they can get this in. Ball almost brought in by Blackshear. Almost intercepted by Quentin Corriott, and he's kicking himself because it was right in his hands.
Well, Corriott has been real quiet today. He's got a groin pull, and he's got a nagging shoulder injury, but he almost came up with this. He's right there, 44, slides back in his zone, looks at the quarterback, sees the cross, and that's a ball he should have had.
Well, then Blackshear nearly had it. Second and 10. Draw play. They lose. Pat Henry all over Lewis Sheffield.
Well, Pat Henry has controlled the center all day. We talked earlier about that dislocated elbow. He obviously has recovered from that. He is getting great penetration around the center.
So on third and 12, the play of the day for the Tech offense, and timeout as the Aggies shuffle personnel on defense. They wanted to get Kerry Vincent in, and they probably wouldn't have gotten him in time to avoid disaster. So they did the right thing.
How to improve your home involves some difficult decisions.
You know, we could use a bigger kitchen.
Nuh-uh, a new bath.
Uh-uh, kitchen.
A new bath.
We could use a...
At NCNB, we don't think financing should be one of them.
Okay, a bath. Upstairs.
Upstairs.
That's why we've set up a loan information line. Call with your questions or stop by and see a loan specialist. Then tell us what's on your mind.
Okay, I got it. A garage.
Uh-uh, a deck.
A garage.
1-800-ASK-NCNB.
Sweetheart.
The loan source.
Yes?
I want a deck.
We'll be right back.
If your face were square, shaving would be simple. If your face were flat, any razor would do. But your face has curves. You need the revolutionary Schick Tracer, the first razor with a blade that flexes to trace every curve on your face. Compared to other razors, Tracer puts more of the blade edge against your skin. For real faces, just like yours. Tracer from Schick traces every curve on your face.
Wouldn't it be great if there was a country club just for regular guys and a few things were changed, like monster carts allowed on course? Water hazards shall no longer be hazardous. Spikes encouraged in the clubhouse. Only really great premium beer served. Like cold-filtered Keystone and Keystone Light. Bottle beer taste in a can.
Hey, I'm in the sand again.
All right.
Nice shot.
Thanks. Wouldn't that be great?
Dave, there's Bob Davey. He's the defensive coordinator for this A&M team. He signals in the calls. Every time I see him, he always says, don't forget I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Third and 12. Ball for Hill. Frazier almost gets the pickoff, and it'll be fourth and 12. And Frazier, after back-to-back flags, feels a little better about things.
Well, that's where I would have gone because they've had a confrontation, obviously. There's Mitchell lining up. Now, this is just a go pattern down the side. Frazier had great position. There was just not a chance that that ball was going to be caught.
Elliott will try a 39-yarder with a slight angle left to right. Jeff Hume, the holder, flag down. Kick is no good, but we'll see if they'll get another shot at it. I think the Raiders are going to say that Frazier from the corner was offside.
Well, let me ask you a question. I know that the kick was no good, and they have the chance to re-kick. But do you go for seven again?
I like your first idea. They're going to need still seven on fourth down. Maybe you come up, try and draw them offsides, and then see what happens. 4 yards and penalties than Tech has in total offense. Mercy. Well, they won't mess with it. They'll try a 34-yarder. And Elliott again, no good. Very uncharacteristic of one of the steadiest kickers in the Southwest Conference.
See him trying to inch that thing in there.
Not this time. Big difference emotionally, more so than on the scoreboard. If he hits it, they're still down 17. But you blow another opportunity, and that's been, as you pointed out, their theme this year, and you give it right back to the Aggies, having dodged a big bullet and still leading by 20. Richardson's had a nice long rest on the side, so has Hill, and he squirts forward for five. Quincy White, wing goes back up, and weak inside linebacker tackling Greg Hill.
If you're R.C. Slocum, what you're saying right now to your quarterback is go back out, take control of this football game, get two or three first downs, and take the emotional lift that recovery of the onside gave Texas Tech. Take it back away from them.
Hill nearing another 100-yard day. What a freshman year he is having. He's dragged down for maybe a loss of one by Fred Petty, the nose tackle out of Chicago. Leading tackler along that three-man defensive line.
And Fred Petty really plays that nose position different than most linemen. He plays it very, very close. We've seen the two offside penalties that he's had early. But he plays very, very close, so he gets his hands on the center quickly. Doesn't allow him to get contact.
Out of the shotgun, Richardson. Almost intercepted by Wingo. As Doug Carter swung out of the backfield and lost his footing. If Wingo grabs that, he's got 25 yards of fresh green AstroTurf in front of him. It's been a restful afternoon for David Davis, only his second kick, and Saul still hoping for his first return of his junior year. Saul to work from his 28, not much. Return of 4 on a kick of 49 yards by Davis.
There's a couple little youngsters. That's Carson and Shelley and Kelly.
And Camden.
Now, excuse me, Camden is that one. Right. And the, we watched them on their birthday. We're here in Texas Tech, and now they're 3 years old.
The family of Tech Assistant Sports Information Director Kelly Robinson just had their third birthday, I think, this week. NC State from behind to survive against Georgia Tech. Ball chased by Englund, but he got away, and he will keep for nice first down yardage to the 36 before he's tripped up by Jason Atkinson. He is not the passer that Jamie Gill is, he'll admit that, but in a situation like this where he knows they're going to come at him, his scrambling ability is a lot better than Gill, and he might be, in this type of situation, a better weapon than even the starter.
He certainly will be if he's able to get outside that pressure. Doesn't have to stay in that pocket because it gives his receivers more time to get open.
Had some room, goes incomplete, slightly behind Mike Honeycutt. Second time he has looked for Honeycutt, and it'll be 3rd and 6. Paul, who led Dallas Carter to the state championship 3 years ago, walked on at Tech, and he had plenty of offers. It wasn't that he couldn't get a scholarship, but he decided early on this is where he wanted to play, and even if they didn't have enough scholarships, he wanted to come here, and his parents could afford to pay their first year's worth of tuition, and now he's on scholarship, and boy, Spike Dykes glad he is. They might not have gotten that snap in time, or perhaps a movement on the right side of the offensive line. Charlie Biggers, the tackle.
They've gone on that first count so many times that when he walked up there, Biggers thought he was going on it and dropped back off the line. You really need to change that snap count. It makes your offensive linemen concentrate more on what they have to do.
That was on 3rd and 6, so now 3rd and 11. Blackshear, Hooper, and Stinnett, all right, Hill left. And Honeycutt in motion. Caught at the 47 for the first down by Rodney Blackshear. First catch of the day. And it goes for 16 yards.
Blackshear caught that back across his body. He was almost sitting down when he caught this ball. It's thrown behind him. He reaches back and makes a nice catch on the play to pick up that first down yardage. And he even signals first down.
Well, the guy who led the conference with 973 receiving yards last year finally gets his first catch today. And ball went right back to him, right through his hands. Got to be some rust, although that was an inexcusable drop, and he's got to be a little on the rusty side. Went out after the fourth play of the opening game against Cal State Fullerton with a fractured leg and only coming back to near 100%. He's not quite there today. Maybe 90-95 was the estimate of the coaching staff. So 2nd and 10. Anthony Lynn spins and loses the ball. Still loose. Aggies have it at midfield.
Looked like Marcus Buckley might have come up with that ball. What a play by Buckley. This is a little underneath pass. It's almost like a screen. And Lynn, when he does, he gets real careless with the football and just kind of bobs it out there. You see how he doesn't have it into his body? Watch Buckley come in there, number 9. Just reaches out and just snags that ball.
Wheeler, the nose tackle, made the hit, but he didn't really cause the fumble. Lynn just didn't pack it in, as you said, and Buckley's caused a fumble and recovered a fumble today. And again, the Red Raiders come away with nothing in the Aggie end of the field. Hill to the short side with a flag down. Let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the Raycom Network.
You're watching 39 KHTV Houston.
Good look at the junior from Fort Worth, Marcus Buckley at Jones Stadium in Lubbock. Dave Farnett and Dave Rowe, A&M by 20 in a series which in this stadium over the last six meetings has featured six games decided by an average of 2.5 points per game. This one breaks the mold with 2:24 in the third quarter and a mark off for holding against A&M. Richardson again looks deep, tight end overthrown slightly, going for short, who had beaten Dubisky. This Aggie passing attack today, a lot like the Baylor attack we saw last week. They don't throw often, but when they do, they don't mess around. They go for big yards.
They throw high percentage passes. They like those one-on-one situations where you've got the linebacker coming, trying to cover the tight end off the line, those type of plays, and they are very, very good high percentage completion passes.
Richardson on the day is 6 of 12. He has averaged 20 yards on those six completions. And that one intended for Tony Harrison, who has been pretty well shut down today. Coverage was by Tony Brown. Aggie offensive coordinator Bob Toledo checking to play sharp. What's he got for third and 19?
Well, Bucky looks over, gets the number, then he looks down on his wristband there. That's their hit chart. He'll signal in like play seven. Looks down, picks out play seven, and calls that.
Out of the shotgun with Hill and Simmons. Both flaring out. Petty gives chase. Good block by Randy Simmons, but they still chase Richardson out of bounds and a flag for a late hit.
Boy, that is a terrible play if you're a Texas Tech player. You've just chased your quarterback out of bounds on third down. You've chased him out of bounds. You've got the fourth down play. They're going to have fourth down. You're going to get the ball back, and then you commit a personal foul. Now Richardson looked like he was going to pull up here, but then all of a sudden went back out to the outside. Now right in here, see, he's easing up. And there's the hit out of bounds.
Sean Jackson, 98, delivered that hit. And at halftime in Austin, Texas may be on their way to 26 straight wins over the Owls. Is that a frustration hit on the part of Jackson? As Auburn loses, look at this.
That's a shocker. Southern Mississippi upsets Auburn 10-9.
The SEC takes a hit. Now, how much frustration is that on Sean? I mean, not that it's excusable.
No, it's there's no excuse for something like that, but I think it is a lot of frustration.
Quick pitch, Hill needs a block. Cuts it back, look out. They're not going to catch Greg Hill.
Hill, I'll tell you one thing. Hill is unbelievable. I'd run him until I either proved he was the best running back in the Southwest Conference or else he proved to be human. Because he runs just, it's amazing. He broke at least one tackle that time that would have brought down most backs. Someone had him by the back and just raked them down, almost raked them down from behind, breaks the tackle, accelerates, and as you say, once he gets cleared, nobody will catch him.
He's at his most dangerous.
Hey, Hill, baby. I love you, baby.
You know, that is most dangerous when you almost have him, because that's when you see that cutback ability.
Well, watch here. There's a pile now. He's not going to make it outside. Now he cuts back. Now somebody gets him right there. There's one move. Looks like somebody had him around the waist. Now the acceleration, and he's off to the run.
Only guy who had a shot was 42, Quincy White, and he tried an arm tackle waist high.
Arm tackles are not going to bring this young man down. But I am just amazed at the ability to see backside that he has. That's where he makes almost all his yardage, makes that cut, gets in the open, and he just flies.
And Saul is a sprinter, speed type safety. He'll run away from
him. Hey, mama! Hey, go, pal! Hey.
Yo, I see you at the wall! I see you at the wall!
Well, with 138 yards, he can say hello to whoever he wants.
And you know, by the end of his career, they're going to hope he says hello to the Heisman. He has had that type of start to his career at Texas A&M. Touchback. Red Raiders with a minute 55 in the third, now down 34-7.
And as we look at that scoring play, scoring drive, I should say, four plays, 50 yards. Remember what set that up. A penalty out of bounds. It was going to be fourth down. They were going to have to punt, give the ball up. Instead, they give him a first down. The very next play, he runs for the touchdown. Those are the type of things that just kill you if you're a coach.
And Robert Hall knows they're going to start teeing off. Anthony McDowell, the senior from Killeen, bothered by nagging injuries all year. Not a whole lot of practice work for him. A&M, as we said, coming in the top scoring unit in the conference, and Tech down by about a touchdown per game over last year. Down to a minute 30 in the third. And a whistle, but no flags. Not sure what this is about.
I think the 25-second clock didn't get started. That's usually the signal when he puts his hand up to restart the 25-second clock.
Ball back. Here comes Buckley. Got away. And again fumbles at the 17. But the Raiders would appear to have it. And they do. Kiefer Chatham causing the fumble.
Boy, and I'll tell you this, Robert Hall just gets crunched back here. He's got no place to step up. There's around the outside. Now watch. No seam up there. They've got him just pegged back in there, and there's the crunch from the backside.
They do a good job of breaking your arms if you got the ball, those Aggie defenders. Third down, 13. Deep for Blackshear and slightly overthrown. That's the type catch he made last year, and they're just a hair off on their timing this year. Story of their season, really.
It really has been. They have been so close in different opportune times, and they just have not capitalized. That onside kick that they recovered in the third period, that could have changed the entire complexion of the football game if they're able to score there.
Bounds already this year has set a Southwest Conference single game record, 52.1 at Wyoming. He's 52-2 today, and this is Kevin Smith's first return to the 39. That one goes 53 yards. He may rewrite all the single season records, both for Tech and the conference this year. Next week, we look forward to our first trip to Waco to see the high-ranked undefeated Baylor Bears take on the Rice Owls, much improved under Fred Goldsmith. That will be from Floyd Casey Stadium in Waco next Saturday. We hope you can join us. That Rice-Baylor series last couple of years has been as close as this A&M Tech series has been until today in Lubbock. McAfee, second effort, third effort to midfield.
Dave McAfee made 7 yards after he was hit. Should have been about a 2 to 3 yard gain. As it is, he picks up a first down. What great leg strength.
Grant Taft's turn for those violent yards.
Right, yards after your hit.
Any coach likes to see that when you're up already by 27, that type effort. And we come to the end of the third quarter. Raiders had some chances, but only cashed in one. Aggies 34-7 as we head to the fourth at Jones Stadium in Lubbock, Texas.
Gallery Furniture announces Imaginations, an innovative new bedroom set from Lexington Furniture. Check out these many features on this multifaceted bedroom set. And the drawers, of course, the drawer fronts are white. However, if you'd like a little color in your bedroom, no problem. Here we have peach or aqua. Simply put it right on. Imaginations, an innovative new bedroom set from Lexington Furniture, on sale for you right now at Gallery. Gallery Furniture really will save you money.
So we put in this new heat pump, and our bills are really
down.
Exactly.
Must be a Lennox.
Get up to $750 in U.S. savings bonds with the purchase of selected Lennox equipment.
Weak service has no slick salesman, no gimmicks, just 19 years of dependability, integrity, and value. Call me for the ultimate in air conditioning.
Since 1918, Way Engineering has been serving the greater Houston area.
Call Way Engineering for dependable installation and quality service.
Attaboy, Dave.
Prices are low at Subway, but I'd rather focus on sandwiches. People call them hoagies or heroes or submarines because they're shaped like submarines. But we call them Subway sandwiches. Our 6-inch meatball sub features meatballs and sauce on bread I just baked, all for a low economical price. I won't say how low, but you'll probably find enough in the cushions of your couch.
For 25 years, Subway has quietly made some of the best sandwiches anywhere, like the 6-inch meatball sub. Only $1.69, only at Subway.
Southwest Conference Football on Raycom is being brought to you by Southwest Airlines, by Dr. Pepper, by Schick Tracer, and by NCNB. $50,577 sitting and standing at Jones Stadium as the fourth quarter gets underway. First and 10, A&M, their own 49-yard line. Richardson remains the quarterback, and Randy Simmons turned back and dropped at his 45. The senior from McKinney overcoming a strained knee before the year and a bruised shoulder the last couple of weeks. How good are they going to be if they're healthy?
Oh. Well, I'm looking at this running list of running backs. I think of Rodney Thomas, McAfee, Hill. You got Carter. We haven't even heard from Gross today. We got Simmons. That's a six great running back.
This will be McAfee. And again, yardage after contact to the 45. The numbers through three quarters. How dominant have the Aggies been? Very.
Tech 1 yard rushing. That's amazing. 87 total yards.
Time of possession about 2-1. A lot of times that number is meaningless, but not today. The Syracuse touchdown by Kadri the Missile Ismail. 44 yard catch to put the Orangemen on top of number one Florida State. Aggies need four. Richardson out of the tackle. He'll get the first down before Dubisky knocks him out at the 34. Whatever they have needed from their senior from Baton Rouge, they've gotten today.
Well, one question I would raise right now is, of course, why is Bucky Richardson in there? Sprained his toe early in the game. He's had a strained arch. It's time to put the young guy in. Let him have a little bit of experience in this situation. It's time to take your number one quarterback and stand him over next to the head coach.
But on the other hand, this head coach has seen leads vanish already this year on the road. He will be none too liberal about protecting leads the rest of probably his entire career. McAfee weaving to the 31. When you have happened what Slocum had happen at Tulsa, you just never forget that.
Yeah, you're gun shy. It was almost as if in that game, it was almost as if he had pulled out his players to ease off with that big halftime lead and then couldn't get the machine started back up. And had they beaten Tulsa, they'd be a top 10 team also.
And he thinks the same way we do. If they don't fumble on the first play of the third quarter of that game, they beat Tulsa. Maybe the Tulsa comeback never gets started, and they'd be in the top 10. They just keep running McAfee. Licio on the tackle at the 27. So maybe we've seen all of GHT for this 138-yard afternoon. I think any of these six that you're talking about on most college offenses would be the bell cow. He'd be the guy running 20, 30 times a game. Third and three, McAfee is the lone setback. And on the option, Richardson will keep and get the first down.
Boy, did he freeze Licio, Mike Licio, on the corner. When Richardson came down there, he had the toss possibility, and he just froze Mike Licio. Watches down the line. There's Licio, 91. See, frozen. Sees the seam. That's what the great leader for this A&M offense does. Picks up the first down.
Richardson came into this year well within reach of the all-time conference quarterback rushing career record held by Marty Akins of Texas. Given health, he should set that new record this year. McAfee to the short side, runs out of room at the 20. Clock rolls down near 11 minutes. Harry Dias on the tackle. McAfee and Simmons, both in their senior years, both expected to inherit most of the opportunities that Darren Lewis has had the last several years. They're both banged up before the opener. Greg Hill goes for 212, and they are suddenly thrust into secondary roles.
And how do you keep somebody out with 4-4 speed like a Greg Hill? He said, only 100 yards or more makes me satisfied.
On second and eight, a couple. Saul up from free safety. Raider coaches, defensive coordinator Carlos Maynard said Saul played his best game at Tech last week. That's saying something. Gracie Saul, they called the natural, with 15 career interceptions coming in. And better than a year and a half still to go. Here they come on third and six. Only one man on the pattern, and Richardson can't find him, so he's dropped by Licio. They sent one man deep left side, Ryan Matthews. Richardson rolled the other way and then was completely screened off by the Raider rush. And it'll be fourth down. Happy to welcome those of you joining us on Prime Network and its nationwide family of regional sports cable networks. In Lubbock, all Aggies, 34-7, 9-23 and counting, as Venatulius will come on and try a 43-yarder. He hit from that distance and 44 yards last week. And he's good here. The A&M lead is 30, and we'll return after this from Southwest Airlines.
I grew up in Texas.
On this, our 20th anniversary, Southwest Airlines proudly unfurls Lone Star One, a high-flying tribute to the indomitable spirit that makes Texas a true state of mind.
Shining in the Texas sky, the Lone Star is flying high.
Felix Popo.
Upon graduation from Escoffier, some of these culinary masters go to London or Rome.
Andre Ligo.
Others go to sea and work their magic on Norwegian Cruise Line. No cruise line caters to food the way we do. Norwegian Cruise Line. The best vacation you've ever had. To say nothing of the chocolate cake, a la André Legault.
In the art of making beer, no one has explored the essence of refreshment like Coors. And now we've discovered a way to double chill a beer, to lock in the refreshing dry cold of the Rockies. The result is a unique cold sensation and a finish as clean as ice. Introducing Double Chilled Coors Dry. Only Coors does it. Coors Dry has it. Cold from the start, clean to the finish. Coors Dry. Feel the chill.
Here's today's game tracer, brought to you by the Schick Tracer. Another 100-plus yard day for Greg Hill. 428 picked up, 87 allowed by A&M. And Robert Hall only 33% through the air. Aggies by 30 with 9:08 to play. Then Atulius to kick to either Marshall or Blackshear. Actually to neither. To about the sixth row in that grassy open end zone. And the battle begins.
The kid's saying, I don't have to give that ball back. I'm keeping it.
This isn't arena football. You can't keep it. If you're having any breakup in our transmission today, it's sunspots. It's not your set. It's nothing we can control. It's an atmospheric disturbance, temporary condition, so please bear with us. Overthrown for Blackshear, who has been really totally taken out of the game today by the A&M secondary.
This is tee-off time for Texas A&M. This big lineman can just get back there. Don't worry about anything. Get great pressure on Robert Hall.
If you weren't with us early, Jamie Gill out with a badly bruised left shoulder as he was sacked by Sam Adams in the first quarter. And it's been Robert Hall's game the rest of the way. Deep for Lloyd Hill and too deep. What a frustrating first 2 years in his career. The Achilles problem last year, knee problem this year. Robert Hall weighed in at about 150 pounds when he enrolled as a walk-on at Tech. He has picked up about 20 since then. He's still a string bean, 6 feet, 170 pounder. That ball out across the 30 to Vincent Brandon. Sophomore transfer out of Waco has his sixth catch of the year. And enough for a first down.
That's what Tech needs to do. They need to get some respectability out of this football game. Right now, they have got to be able to move the football because it doesn't look like Jamie Gill's going to be back next week, and they have to rally around Robert Hall. So they need to get some positive things going right now.
They continue to run on first down, and this is Byron Bam Morris, freshman out of Cooper, Texas, the brother of Chicago Bear receiver Ron Morris, highly recruited, and the second leading high school rusher in the history of Class 2A in Texas. Sat out because of academics last year. 89, he led all Texas high school running backs with 2,972 yards. Goes Hall at the 26. It was Buckley on the blitz.
Marcus Buckley. You know, they compare him with the great linebackers that they've had here, like Johnny Holland and Roper, Wallace, and William Thomas. He may be in that same class. Great speed. The outside, he just makes that blitz look so easy when he comes from there.
Talking about academics, he's a former Prop 48. Who has built up his grade point average to 2.8. He's as proud of that as he is anything he does on the football field, and he should be. Third and 15. Lloyd Hill will be close. It all depends on the mark. He needed the 43 And that's where Kevin Smith brought him down.
When you see crossing plays like that working, you want to say, why don't they work earlier? Why haven't they gone to that earlier? There's nobody's going to stay with Hill one-on-one. He's got that type of speed. Blackshear, the same thing. Those crossing patterns have been very effective.
Blackshear, a nice catch of a low-thrown ball, and he'll have another first down. Coverage by Kerry Vincent. Well, why don't they do it early?
Well, the first thing, they haven't been able to establish the run. Now they've thrown the run to the wind. I mean, it's out of here, and they've got to pass every down. But had they been able to establish the run, then you don't allow those linebackers to step back and cover those zones.
That's Brandon splitting double coverage to the 28.
Maybe they heard us. That's three straight. Right over top of the middle, little slant patterns. You run down there, plant, go inside, and the ball's been delivered well. And it also doesn't take a lot of time.
Bates and Frazier had the coverage. He went right between the two. Raiders continue with 6:40 to play. Buckley almost offsides on the quick blitz. Morris finally dragged down. Picked up two where none appeared possible. Chatham finally wrestled him down.
I'll tell you, if Robert Hall will come up there and go on two, he will catch them offsides every time. He just stands there, and it's like he calls the ball every time on one. When he walks up there, he just, hut, boom, they snap the ball. And now I mean to tell you, A&M is getting a tremendous jump off the ball.
Going on one again. Here they come. Pass for Hill, knocked away by Frazier. He's had kind of a bittersweet day. He's made some plays, but he was victimized by the back-to-back penalties on the only Red Raiders scoring drive of the day.
And his counterpart, Kevin Smith, across the way, has been awfully silent today. I can't remember the last time I saw a ball thrown over in Kevin Smith's area.
Yeah, Smith coming into this year had an outside shot at the NCAA career interception record, but doesn't look like it's going to happen. People respect him too much. Freehill picked off. Patrick Bates has his third interception of the year. The first two came against LSU, and the sophomore out of Galveston Ball, who transferred from UCLA, saw this one all the way. A&M by 35-47 until celebration time begins.
They're right. New diet Dr. Pepper does taste more like regular Dr. Pepper.
So let's have another.
New diet Dr. Pepper. There's no stopping the taste.
I can't tell you how it feels when you're way out there on your own tracking the bad guys. How it feels leading a skilled team that's the eyes and ears of the whole outfit. When all your training is coming alive. But finding those tanks and telling the air cavalry right where to hit them? I can tell you exactly how that feels.
Some folks will do when they catch somebody trashing Texas highways.
Don't mess with Texas!
Hello?
This is Thelma downstairs. What was that?
Diet Dr. Pepper. It tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
Can I try one?
I'll send George right down.
Bucky Richardson done today. 12 carries for 74 yards and 3 touchdowns. And in doing so, he has passed Quinn Grovey and Lindy Berry and moves within 204 yards of the all-time Southwest Conference rushing quarterback Marty Akins of Texas. Jeff Granger in the game along with McAfee and Cliff Gross in the eye. McAfee out to the eight as we pause briefly for station identification on the Raycom network.
You're watching 39 KHTV Houston.